evening, ladies and gentlemen. Welcome to Harbor Station. Jim Hennessy on Primetime Sports and TVNB. Nice to have you tuned in as the Players St. John Flames take to the ice. We got a great tally for you tonight. St. John Flames take on the St. John's Maple Leafs. And it was a battle last night here at Harbor Station. 3-3 tie between these teams. That means the Leafs sit in second place here in the Canadian Division. The Flames are in fourth and really desperately need a win in front of the hometown crowd tonight. With some highlights of last night's game, let's go to the roll right now and see what we got for you. We saw the Flames jump out to an early lead here as the game got started last night at Harbor Station. Flames steal it in the Leafs zone. Quick shot, top hand corner. Flames on the board, 1-0 lead. Here we see the Flames having trouble trying to clear the puck out of their own zone. The Leafs attacking, and there's the tying tally. We've got a tie game with 1 goal apiece. Leafs break out here, breakaway, and a nice move, tic-tac-toe. The goal is in, and the Leafs lead 2-1. The Flames get the equalizer here, breaking across the blue line. Good effort, and a nice tap home. And a tie game, 2 goals apiece. Chris Clark with a nice effort. Here comes the Flames looking for the go-ahead goal. Nice pass. Excellent effort from the Flames. Varlamov with a real nice tip. They lead 3-2. There's a play that they thought was going to be a high sticking call, but the Leafs did get that equalizer. Flames looking for the win here. The net gets knocked off the moorings. They thought they've got the winner. Varlamov raised his hands, but the ref says no goal. So we end up with a 3-3 tie between the St. John Flames and the St. John's Maple Leafs. This is a real big game for both teams tonight. Like we said, the Leafs are in second place in the Canadian Division. Flames are in fourth. Levant Zuber gets the start between the pipes for the St. John Flames. Jimmy White played outstanding for the St. John's Maple Leafs last night, but believe it or not, he is suffering from a case of vertigo and will not be starting tonight. As we get ready for action, right now we go for the singing of the Canadian National Anthem.
Shaw with the singing of the national anthem. Both teams now going back to tap their respective goaltenders. And the starting goaltenders again tonight, Levent Zuber for the Flames. And at the other end of the ice on the right-hand side, you will see Jamie Hodgson.
Both goaltenders only had the one start this season, and Hodgson had three starts this season, but one loss. So obviously he got yanked somewhere along the line. And Levent Zuber, same thing. He's got one start, but one loss. The goals against averages, Super's got 3.33 and Hodgson is a 5.49. So fairly evenly matched two goaltenders here. Both coaches, I think, making good choices here and just see what these kids can do.
And Coach Lou Crawford of the Leafs had to be a little more satisfied with the result last evening as opposed to Jim Playfair.
I would say so. I mean, the Flames had to play catch-up hockey all night last night. And, I think he's got some veteran guys here, but they just don't seem to be picking up the game and playing like a veteran squad that they are. I mean, you have a few rookies, so to speak, but they've been playing in the East Coast League, been playing hockey long enough. They should know the game. Coach should be just there to guide them along.
South Park, Kachuk, and Ilomo will start it off for the Flames. Right off of the opening faceoff now. Flames pick it up just inside of their own blue line. St. Croix has it. St. Croix right between the faceoff circles. Sends it up the right-hand side. They'll send one into the Leafs corner. Back to pick it up now for the Leafs. They'll take it on the boards. That one coming off of the stick of number 23, Ponikarowski. Ponikarowski gets it as far as center ice, where it's sent back in by Ilomo. In forechecking now for the Flames. Clark out there. He'll try and tie it up on the boards. Does a good job. Clark with a good game last night. Wants to try and keep things going. Leafs, meantime, bring it back the other way. In over the blue line. In control now. Hackenson has it. Hackenson tied up on the far boards. Now the Flames pick it up again. Here comes Tkachuk. Tkachuk over to Clark. As Clark was going to the players' bench. And we're going to have a stoppage of play.
I think we got a penalty here. Too many men on the ice for the Leafs here tonight. So the Flames are going to get a chance to go on the power play right off the bat. Leafs guilty of the line change there. And just too many men on the ice. Not getting off the line changes quick enough. As the gate is open for the St. John's Maple Leafs.
And it looks as though Frakas is going to be the one who goes. And whenever you have a too many men on the ice, the blame usually falls back to who?
Well, it goes to the players because they know who they have to pick up, who their line change is going to be with. And if they jump the boards too soon and the guy, you know, linesmen usually give you 15 feet at least anyway. And I mean, that's fair enough, I think. And it's not supposed to be that much, but they do give them at least that much. And if you can't get off the ice quick enough, wham, you're going to be guilty of too many men on the ice, as the Leafs are right now.
Time of the penalty, 48 seconds. Frakas, too many men on the ice. And the Flames on their first power play opportunity tonight. They have control inside center ice on their end. Pass comes across towards the right-hand side. Now the Flames have to go back inside of their own blue line. Martin back to pick it up. He'll just send it back to his defensive partner, so they'll regroup back behind their goaltender, Zuper. Long pass comes all the way up. A little bit of miscommunication. Fata can't catch up with it. Leafs try to send it out over the blue line. They'll just manage to do that, so the Flames have to hightail it back inside of their own zone. Now Fata up again. Brings it over the line. They'll try and get a little bit of control, but as Fata come off the other side, the Leafs just send a long one down the ice. 1 minute, 13 seconds left in the Flame power play as they make their way up towards center ice. Pass goes in. Walser fires one all the way. He'll go to the player's bench. On comes number 24, Scoville. Puck comes back to the point. Dupont playing this evening. Ties it up. Botterill takes his man out into the boards. Puck comes back to Dupont. Cross ice pass to Walser. Pass in front. Tkachuk shot it. But that went off of the stick of DJ Smith into the open corner. And again, the Flames have to go back inside of their own blue line. 40 seconds now remaining in the power play. Flames still inside of their own blue line on the left wing. They'll bring it up over center ice, in over the line, four across the line. Shot saved by Hodgson. Rebound just lays there. As Varlamov couldn't get a hold of it, they'll keep the pressure on. Puck into the corner. Now Tkachuk has it. He'll drop it to the point. Dupas swings around. Back to Tkachuk again. Another shot. Hodgson saves it, and he's going to hang on. Oh, some good pressure by the Flames.
That was real good pressure in around the front of the net there, and Hodgson couldn't smother up that puck, but the Flames couldn't bounce on the rebound either. The puck skated over to the far corner, but Flames really early in the power play were miscommunicating, not getting the passes on the stick. They were overpassing the puck to their wingers, and they got to get a little more communications there, a little more talk out there, and things will smoothen out.
Face off inside of the Leaf blue line in the far corner. Bark out there again. Breton. Breton to take the faceoff. Pinching in is Montador. He'll go right to the top of the faceoff circle. Breton ties up his player in the corner. Now he comes around to pick it up back behind the lead goal. Breton tries to send it to the point. Does Montador. Looks. Takes a shot. That's blocked in front. Goes off of the legs of Antipov. Flames still in control. 2 minutes, 2 seconds now left in the penalty. They'll get it back to Montador again at the right point. Cross ice pass. That shot in front. Blocked by the Leafs. Now on the turnover, they'll come up to center ice on the left wing. Puck goes into the corner. Antipov. Zuper comes out to play it off the boards. Long pass. That was intended for the defenseman, but it'll come all the way back. And hustling back inside of his own zone is Tyler Harlton. Harlton takes a little breather. Now he makes his way up the right side. Lobs one over everybody's head. That goes all the way back inside of the Flame blue line. Interception at the blue line. Leafs swing it around the front of the goal. Clark picks it up. Here comes Clark down the right side. Hold down from behind. No penalty. Play continues. The fans want one. As Roche, the other forechecker. Leafs can't get it past center ice. As the Flames bottle them up inside of their own blue line. Now the Flames bring it in over the line. Shot there. Hodgson makes an easy save. Cradles it momentarily. Sends it into the corner. Now Fata takes another shot. Blocker saved by Hodgson. And Barry Hudson looks a little hard as he makes a couple of saves, but doesn't seem to have that soft touch.
He seems to be really fighting the puck here tonight, and he's taking everything on the chest area or anywhere he seems to be hitting them. He doesn't seem to be wanting to play the puck. Rebounds are dropping out in front of him, and he doesn't know what to do with it, but the Flames are getting real sloppy clearing their own zone. They tried to make one clearing attempt out there, and it went off the boards, and the lead player was right there at the blue line to pick it up. But Flames had 5 shots on goal right now. The Leafs have none, so sometimes a goaltender likes to have a few shots to get them warmed up a little bit and keep them in the game.
That's guaranteed. And Hudson, again, so far facing the bulk of the work. And he'll have to get fed with another faceoff. Again, his proper side in the right corner. Ketchuk in to take the faceoff. Out there with Alomo. Dropping the point by St. Croix. Puck goes into the corner. They'll tie it up on the boards. Ketchuk tried to come in, but it's the Leafs who pick it up. Now the Leafs up the left-hand side. Hackinson brings it over center ice. His pass was foiled by the Flame defense. Alomo now right at his own blue line on the near boards. And that one's going to be ruled an offside, so we'll have a face-off. 15 minutes, 51 seconds left here in first period action. 0-0 the score, and the shots on goal vary 5-0. So the Flames getting some rubber towards the goaltender Hudson. But again, as you mentioned earlier, a little too cute maybe on that power play opportunity. And the key is that they have to get somebody in front of the goal.
Well, that's what Big Dave Roach, I think that's his job. And you see on the power play, he's been out there in front of the net. And no shock to anybody that's been watching the Flames. He's a big guy out there. You can't move him.
Kenny Karup on the ice now for the Flames. But lays back inside of the Flames' blue line. They'll get it up the left-hand side. Now they'll shovel it in towards the Leaf end. Karup in doing the forechecking. Leafs, though, have control. Hackinson just leaves it on the right-hand side. Long pass. That was intended for Konica Rovolsky. Puck goes inside of the Flames' blue line. They'll tie it up in on the far corner. Hackinson comes in to pick up the loose puck. He loses an edge, goes down, taken out on the boards by Scoville. Scoville trying to tie him up, comes up with the loose puck, goes with a backhand, and just jumps it down the center ice. Leafs on the right wing. They'll bring it in over the blue line, try to drop it to the point. That goes right to the Flame forward, and he can't get anywhere as that one went between his legs. Varlamov, some good neutral ice play. Flames have to go back inside of their own blue line. Back to pick it up. Scoville again. Brings it up to center ice. Now Varlamov in over the line. Varlamov shot saved by Hodgson. Took that one up high. Flames look for the rebound. And the Leafs scurry around a little bit. And under the pressure, they'll dump it down the ice. And we're going to have another icing call.
Once again, that's another shot that Hodgson took up high. Looks around afterwards because he does not know where the rebound is. But the defense of the Leafs are really playing good here tonight. They're clearing the puck out. Unfortunately, they had to take an icing there, but that's a chance you got to take. Pressure get a little hot. Get out of the kitchen.
Exactamo. That's exactly what my daddy used to say. If it's too hot, you might as well vacate. But Hodgson, again, a proven goaltender. But tonight, he looks like he's either a little nervous or maybe a little flustered. And maybe the Flames should put a couple along the ice real hard and see if they can distract him a little bit more. But again, traffic going to be the key in front. Good save off of Rico Fatt off of the faceoff as he kicked that right leg out. And the Leafs, again, just send it down the ice. Back to pick it up is Dupont. Dupont, good pass all the way across the boards. Fatt couldn't pick it up clean. Giroux does, though. Giroux sends one into the corner. Leafs will pick it up. Now the Leafs send it up towards center ice. Back pass, puts it right onto the stick. That's intercepted. Roche just turns it back into the corner again. Fatta in, picking up the loose puck. Hands it off to Bureau. Bureau back to the point. They try to pinch it in again. Right into the corner. Fatta races into the left corner to pick it up. Tries to get a little bit of room. Bureau has his stick knocked out of his hands. Here comes a 4-on-2 for the Leafs. And they foil that one real quick. And the Flames just send it down to center ice. Play remains at center as Alomo tried to sneak one through the legs of the defenseman. And the Leafs turn it back the other way. Kravnicek can't get any worse. Clark picks it up. Long pass right over to the left wing. That's picked up by Ketchuk. Ketchuk taken in on the boards. Keeps on going. Puck just lays there. And the Leafs, again, scurrying around in their own zone as Clark picks it up. Hands it off to Ketchuk. Ketchuk back behind the goal. Sends it out in front. Oh, and Clark didn't see that one coming right away. Now he'll get control, puts it back into the corner. Tkachuk back to Clark again, top of the circle, tried to wave at one, and he fanned on it, so the puck was into the open corner. Picking it up for the Leafs is Thornton. Thornton passes it right up the right wing onto the stick of the Flame defense. He'll try it again. Sending up now, Morgan Warren brings it in over the blue line. High wrist shot. Zucker watches that one go over. And the Flames just pinch it down the center ice. 12:48 left here in the first period. 0-0 the score. Flames trying to get something going. Long shot again, fired low and wide. Puck comes back to DJ Smith. He puts it into the corner, tried to send it out in front. Now the Flames again send one down towards the center ice area. Flames send around the front, goes to the backhand, score!
Barlamov there on the backhand, went up high on Hudson. Real good goal, and that's what they need from Barlamov right now.
And again, we talked about that in the pregame show. Varlamov picking up his first goal last night. It was important for him to kick it into high gear right at the opening faceoff. Does a good job. And we've got a 1-0 Flame lead. Time of the goal, 7 minutes, 32 seconds. Varlamov getting the goal. So Varlamov gets his second goal of the regular season at the 7:32 mark. And we'll wait for the official assist. An unassisted goal by Varlamov, his second of the season. And the Flames lead 1-0. Back to the action though. Leafs have it at center ice. Nemirovsky brings it up over towards the blue line. He's got two men trapped inside, so we'll have an offside and a face-off. 12:02 left here in the first period. 1-0 Flames lead. We'll be right back. You're listening to Home Hardware Flames Hockey on Country 94. Of the Leaf blue line. That'll be picked up again by DJ Smith. Smith just lobs one down the center ice, so Martin's going to try it again. Long cross ice pass over to the left wing. That's intended for Roche. He can't pick that one up. Coming back the other way is the captain for the Maple Leafs, number 21, Dempsey. Dempsey has to wait outside of the blue line for his player to get back onside. And Dempsey takes a little shot to the jaw by Montador. Montador just skates away, gets back into position. Fat, a good long pass, puts it onto the other side, right onto the stick of Dave Roche. Roche in it over the blue line. He's squeezed out into the corner boards. Fat races back as Hodgson comes out of the goal to try and steer it away. Now Fat with the backhand puts it right onto the stick of the Leafs, and they'll make their way up the center ice. Pass now right onto the stick or just behind him, and that one there was a little too hot to handle for Alan Rourke. Montador in control. Long pass, puts it right up again onto the stick of the player, and it'll go over and into the stands for a souvenir. So we'll have a face-off just outside of the lead blue line.
You can see a lot of frustration on Rico Fatta. He's given a lot of jabbing and jawing down there. That's not his game. The Leafs trying to get him off his game, and they're really succeeding at that. It's unfortunate because once you get Rico Fatta going, you can't stop him, and then the Leafs are doing their job. They're putting a man on him all the time, and if you keep Rico Fatta off the scoreboard, 9 times out of 10, the visiting team can come out of here with 2 points.
And again, that's one of the things that Fatta's teammates are going to have to pay special attention to. Long shot from the point off of the stick of St. Croix, redirected into the open corner. Flames in doing the forechecking. Botterill in there. Botterill tied up on the boards. Now the Leafs pick it up. They'll send one up the left wing. Nemirovsky gets as far as center ice where he tried to hand it off to a teammate. That's intercepted by the Flames. They'll swing it back the other way. Pass comes in front. Botterill races right to the goal. Penalty coming up. And the referee, Kelly Sutherland, going to haul a high sticking infraction. And I believe, again, it's going to the Maple Leafs.
I believe it is, because the Flames were in on a rush there, and they were trying to hold up, I think it was Graton, trying to hold him up, and he got the stick up a little too high on him.
And that's number 35, Vladimir Antipov.
So he's gone for 2 minutes to the sin bin for high sticking.
So another power play opportunity for the Flames. They lead this game by a score of 1-0, in case you've just tuned in. I'm Steve McDonald along with Barry Johnston. And this is Home Hardware Flames Hockey on Country 94. And again, we'd like to say a special hello to all the shut-ins in the area who can't get out to the game. Glad to have you aboard. Also the viewers tuning in tonight on TVNB. Back in northern New Brunswick, my old alma mater.
Mine too. You didn't know that one, did you?
No, I didn't, Barry.
We didn't get much of a chance to talk before the game started. So.
That's true.
Actually, my own hometown's Bathurst.
Home of the Titan. Face off inside of the lead blue line. Again, the Flames on the power play. We're at the halfway point of the first period. And so far tonight, the Flames have drawn first blood, so to speak. Got one by the starting goaltender, Jamie Hudson. And last night's game, Barry, Jimmy Waite played exceptionally well.
Well, I can only go by what I read and what I've seen on the internet, and I think all indications point that he did play a very, very good game here last night. Brochu, I guess, played a good game also on the other end of things too, but I think Jimmy Waite probably deserved to get the win there last night.
Flames on the power play. Shot comes from the point off of the stick of DuPont. Gingerly one as it goes into the open corner. Kachuk looks for a freebie in front. They'll get it back to DuPont again. Shot fired in front. Redirected. Flames try to gaffle on it. Fata swings at it like a home run hitter. Just misses it. Puck comes back to DuPont again. Shot in front. Leaf defenseman gets in front of that one. Kachuk can't pick it up. Dave Roche does. Hands it off to Fata back behind the goal. Now Roche is going to have to hurry up as he picks it up into the corner. They'll drop it to the point to DuPont again. Kachuk back to DuPont. Shot. That's redirected just wide. Flames, good control, trying to keep the pressure on. But again, Barry, not getting too much action in front of the goal. DuPont back at the point. 1:11 left in the power play. Now Kachuk lays into one. Shot again. Goes off of a skate. Another shot. Score! Federico Fata stopped that pass from the opposite side. And Hodgson was already stretched out as far as he could go. And Rico Fata, his first goal of the season on the power play. The Flames lead by a score of 2-0.
That was a real good, they were playing the puck real good down low. Roche was out front causing a lot of disturbance out there. Hodgson was trying to concentrate on Roche out in front of the net, but then he couldn't keep his eye on Fata sitting off to the corner. The puck came over. Hodgson did make the initial save, but as viewers from TVNB can see, he could not stop Fata from tucking the puck into the short side. And now the Flames are up by a score of 2-0 at 11-11 of the first period.
And I'm sure Rico Fata breathing just a sigh of relief to get the monkey off of his back. And let's watch for Rico Fata for the rest of the game, because his confidence is going to go up. Off of the faceoff. Puck goes into the open corner. Bralimov sends one towards the blue line. Adam Mayer tries to keep it out. Puck goes off of a lineman. Now the Leafs have control. Again, just like a lob one down. That's intercepted. Flames pick it up. And that was number 27, Goodall, who got the pass, but it was off of the hand of one of his teammates, and the linesman not going to give him that one, so we'll have a face-off just inside the Flames.
A lot of Montreal Canadiens fans remember number 27, Marc Bureau. He played some good seasons there in Montreal. Hopefully Calgary can get the same out of him here. A little disgruntled to be sent down to the farm, but you know, he knows what he has to do to get back up to the big time.
And actually, Barry, I've got a good interview with Marc Bureau in the first period intermission, and getting to know him over the last couple of days, and a true, true gentleman. Back to the action. Flames have control back inside of their own blue line. Back to pick it up is Marc Bureau. Bureau, who was born and raised in Montreal. Flames send it in over the line. Fata tried to use that back skate to flip it ahead, but he was just a little too late, so we'll have a face-off just outside of the Leaf blue line.
There's no things anymore such as delayed offside anymore. The league has changed the rule on that a couple of years ago, and players got to really play with the puck in the neutral zone, and it's changed the game a lot. You know, New Jersey Devils had that neutral zone trap going, and you can't really do that much anymore now, but you got to they're trying to clamp down the clutch and grabbing. You get neutral zone hockey, that's what you're going to get, and it's going to be hard for the referees. I mean, they got a tough job out there. There's only three of them out there, and one's got the armband, so it's quite difficult for those guys to call a game.
Martin, inside of his own blue line, taps one off the far boards. That'll make its way down to center ice, where it's picked up there by the Leafs. Bringing it up ice now. Alan Rourke can't get anywhere. Flames just blanket that blue line. Bureau takes his man out. Puck goes into the open corner. Here comes Fatta as Hodgson comes out to play it into the corner. Rico Fatta pitches it back towards the point for Bureau. Back into Fatta again. Puck comes out in front, just lays in the open crease. And now the Leafs try to vacate it out of their own zone. Shot by St. Croix, goes into the open corner. Bureau steals it from Hodgson, and Bureau just can't get it back to the point. Here comes the Leafs now. They'll send it up onto the stick of number 24, LaRivière. LaRivière, known for his toughness in the Quebec Major Junior Hockey League, takes his man out into the boards. That's St. Croix. Puck goes towards the shot. Saved by Zupa. And what a time to get his first shot on goal, right in the glove.
That was a great save by Super, and we got a little rough stuff going on to the left of Super. That's not a good line to be trying to rough things up with, because the Leafs got their fourth line out there, which is their heavy-duty check-in line out there. You got LaRivière, you got Thornton out there, who is still having a word with St. Croix, and that's one guy you don't really want to be mouthing off too much to. His fans remember here last year, Rocky Thompson and him had a go late in the season, and Thornton got the worst of that deal, but no Rocky this year, and there's not too much down there. You look down on the Flames bench that could maybe tussle with Thornton this year.
So far this season, Thornton has been behaving.
So far, so good.
7 minutes, 17 seconds left here in first period action. 2-0 Flame lead. Shots on goal, 10 for the Flames, and one, but it was a dandy by the Leafs. Off of the faceoff now, inside of the Flames blue line. St. Croix takes it off the boards. Here come the Flames. They'll get it up to center ice. Botterill sends one into the open corner. Varlamov races in from the other side, manages to tie it up back behind the goal. Also coming in to help old Varlamov now. The Flames will get it back to the point to St. Croix again. He tries to just shovel it back into the open corner. Leafs Nemirovsky tries to get it out over the blue line, and now they'll get it down ice. Back to pick it up is Varlamov, one of the goal scorers this evening. Varlamov right behind his goaltender. Now makes his way up the left-hand side on the fireboards. Long pass, that's knocked out of midair by number 51, Nemirovsky. And the Leafs swing it back. That play intended for Antropov. Can't get it there. St. Croix wraps one off the boards. Can't get it outside of his own blue line. Long shot again, that's fired into the open corner. Nemirovsky right at the face-off circle. Taken out of the play. Leafs trying to put on a little bit of pressure. Back there, Gratton helping out. Gratton just watching his man. Nemirovsky still has control of the puck, though, as he makes his way back to the point. That's shot and redirected into the open corner. Going to have a penalty. This time it's going against the Flames. So the Flames going to have to be shorthanded here as the Leaf goaltender comes out for the extra attacker. On comes number 27, Bobby House. Puck comes over to the other point. Long shot. Zupar makes a save off of the stick of Nathan Dempsey. But now the Flames going to be shorthanded.
See what the Flames can do here. The Leafs seem to have a little bit of momentum going on their side right now, and not a good time. You're going to be down a man, and the Leafs got the momentum going with 5:47 left to go in the first. We're going to get a holding penalty against Derek Walzer. The guys are out there just a little too long, can't get the line change anyway because the Leafs are putting pressure on into the Leafs in their zone. And sometimes you get a little tired, there's not enough oxygen in the system, and you just reach out, grab a hold of a guy, not thinking the way you would normally if it was just a short shift, but unfortunately, Eric Walls is gone for holding at 5:47.
So with 5 minutes, 47 seconds left in the first period, the Leafs on their first power play advantage tonight. They're down by a pair. Face off to the trapper side of the starting goaltender for the Flames, Levent Zupar. Off of the draw, Flames get it back behind their own goal. They'll rip one around the boards. That should make it all the way down the ice. Daniel Kachuk out on this penalty kill, as is Chris Clark, along with Martin and number 24, Scoville. Lease put it right onto the stick of number 33, and that's Cooper. Cooper lobs one inside of the Flames' blue line. That's picked up, though, by Scoville. Tries to send it out. Can't do it. Leafs keep it in the far corner. Now they'll just send one back behind the goal, try and get somebody open. Back at the point. That shot fired high over the top of the goal. Comes right out in front. And the Flames, Tkachuk, spots some open real estate. And he goes for a line change. On comes Morozic, Rico Fatta. Euro out there also. Leafs will bring it inside of the Flame blue line. They'll send it right back behind the goal onto the stick. Mayer has it now. Mayer on the forehand, top of the circle. Adam Mayer slides it across. That one goes to Cooper, top of the slot. They tried to give it back to Mayer, and it was just a little too hot to handle. And the Flames, again, send one down the ice. 46 seconds left in the power play opportunity for the Leafs. They've managed just two shots on goal here in the first period. Carlton, long cross-ice pass onto the right side for Mayer. He just sends it around the back of the Flames net. In to pick it up now, Travnicek. Travnicek being hounded there by Montador. Montador takes Travnicek out onto the boards, uses his stick to try and get the puck free, but the Leafs still keep control. They'll drop it to the point. Carlton. Carlton has it. Sends it in for Farkas. Farkas at the top of the slot, a little too far. Now a broken stick by the Flames. Shot that's redirected. Goes right to the goaltender, Zuper. And he'll hang on for the whistle. 3:57 to go. 2-0 Flames lead. We'll be right back. You're listening to Home Hardware Flames Hockey on Country 94. Rock on, dude. It's expired. Leafs still inside of the Flame blue line, though. They'll tie it up on the boards. Thornton out there, and he's been a thorn in the side of the Flames. St. Croix takes him out into the corner boards. Leafs shot back out to the top of the slot. That one didn't get through. And the Flames this time elect just to kill a little bit of time. Now the defensive core comes off for a line change. On comes Martin and DuPont. Leafs have it on the left side. They'll get it up to center ice. Host just lobs one into the open corner. Back to pick it up is Martin. Martin, cross ice pass, sends it up the left-hand side. Now they'll swing it over the other way. Varlamov races in to pick it up. He'll tie it up on the boards. Now Varlamov tries to squeeze his way around, but that's intercepted by the Leafs. Rourke takes a breather back behind his goaltender, Hudson. Now Rourke just hands it off. Puck almost stolen there by number 46, Alomo. Tkachuk tries to get a little bit of room inside the line, but the puck squeaks back out to center ice. And DuPont just elects to send it inside of the Leaf blue line. High pass off of the glass. That's going down the ice, but DuPont will get back in time. DuPont puts on the brakes, sends it up the left wing. Flames, long knuckleball pass, no connection there. So they'll have to do it again. DuPont elects just to send it in. Hudson, the goaltender, comes back to play it. TJ Smith sends it around the back of the boards, up the right wing. Here come the Leafs now, cross ice pass. Nemirovsky can't pick it up. Flames lob at the center, intercepted though by number 21, Dempsey. Dempsey in over the line, goes to the wayward side, tried to send it out in front. And that goes right onto the stick of Alomo. He'll send it up to Tkachuk. Tkachuk in the right side to Alomo in front. Alomo tried to go to the backhand, but ran out of room as Hudson held his ground. Montador at the point, fires one, stick saved there by Hudson. And that took a funny hop off the boards, came right into the glove of Hudson, so he's going to hang on, and we'll have a face-off inside the Leafs blue line.
That puck just rolled off the back end of Alomo's stick, and he couldn't get enough wood on it. Like you say, he ran out of room and ran out of time, and Hudson was right there. I noticed tonight Hudson's been having a hard time playing the puck. Whenever he gets the puck, he just doesn't seem to know what to do with it, and I think that's something they have to work on in practices with him. But he's tossed out the puck quite a bit when he's tried to play it, and it's going to cost him big time here tonight if you get the likes of Rico Fatu in there pretty quick, or Tkachuk or Barlamov.
It's like my father always used to say, if the puck bounces away from you all the time when you continuously try to get it, that means you've got hard hands. So again, he's going to have to work on that. And the Leafs working on a 2-0 lead with 1:35 left here in the first period. Fatu inside of the lead blue line, deep in the corner. Gets it back to Roche. Roche shovels one ahead. That was intended for his teammate. Can't keep it in. And the Leafs now swing it back towards center ice. They'll bring it up over the line inside of the Flames blue line. Hackinson races in to try and pick it up. Puck will come all the way back to the point. They'll shovel it towards the front of the goal. St. Croix back to pick it up. And the Flames lob one down the ice. Hustling back is the defenseman Cooper. Cooper, the ex-Flame, sends one up towards his teammate, but that goes right to the goaltender, Super. Shots on goal, 12-3 in favor of the Flames. They lead this game by a score of 2-0.
We're going to get some coincidental minors here. One to Gratton, the other one to Hackinson, or Harkinson. I believe the Flames are going to get one for holding, and the Leafs are going to get one for slashing.
The coincidental minor is handed out by the referee, Kelly Sutherland. And the faceoff will be all the way back inside of the Flame blue line. In the left corner, starting goaltenders again tonight, Jamie Hudson for the Leafs and Levent Zuber for the Flames. A good crowd on hand here tonight at Harbor Station for this second game in two nights against the Leafs. Last night, a 3-3 overtime tie. On the faceoff now, Clark takes the draw, sends it back to his defenseman, Martin. Martin back behind the goaltender, Zuber. Waits a little bit for his key guys to get into position. And that's Varlamov and Clark. Walls are out there also. Flames just elect to send it inside of the lead blue line. Back to pick it up is number 4, DJ Smith. 5 points so far this season. Looking for more. Leafs send it over the blue line, but it's going to win a little too far, so Clark has to elude a check at the blue line. Gets it up as far as the Leaf blue line, but now Mayer picks it up inside of the Leaf blue line. Mayer runs it all the way up the right-hand side, cuts towards center in over the blue line. Passes one over intended for number 21, Dempsey. And Dempsey had it hop over his stick, so that allows the Flames to make their way. Oh, a hip check there. That missed by Mayer. And maybe for the good. And on the ensuing play, the puck was up over the glass as time runs out. But if that hip check would have connected, you don't see too many hip checks nowadays.
No, you don't. And one guy that does come to mind in the Calgary organization that throws a pretty good hip check is Denny Gauthier. And it looked almost like a Denny Gauthier out there with that hip. But like you say, it's a good thing Mayer missed with that, or we would have had a sore hip out there for darn sure. But nonetheless, Flames are leading by a score of 2-0 here in the first period. They lead on shots on goal by a margin of 12-3, which highly unlikely after the way the Leafs played last night. Did you expect them only to have 3 shots? They were 3 quality shots at that, but obviously not enough to get it behind Super, who was playing Super.
And we'll be right back with first period intermission. Let's go back to Brent Moore now for this sports update.
Many choices. Why stay with cable TV? Well, let's see. Cable means reliability, quality, and more channels than ever. It also means digital services like commercial-free music, plus internet connections much faster than a phone line. It also means guaranteed service and installation. No ugly satellite dish, no extra receivers to buy, no extra antennas, and no missing out on local channels. Kind of a no-brainer, isn't it? Cable TV. It's really smart.
hard facts or just coffee shop gossip? Hot Topic lets you tackle the important issues in your area. Live, Wednesdays at 7, only on TVNB.
Hello, New Brunswick. I'm Alan Power, inviting you to join us here on Sports Monday.
And I'm Gary Maxwell. For all the latest in sports in New Brunswick, insight, interviews, and more, keep it right here every Monday night at 8 o'clock on TVNB.
I just missed my bus. Daddy, will you please take me to school today?
I thought you'd never ask.
You're so not funny.
Family.
Want to give your mom a kiss?
Isn't it about time? From the Church of Jesus Christ of Latter-day Saints.
They volunteer to go out in the worst weather imaginable. They put their vessels and lives on the line at a moment's notice. They respond to over 1,700 marine search and rescue incidents and save hundreds of lives each year. Their only payment is the satisfaction of helping others in trouble. They are the Canadian Coast Guard Auxiliary. Practice safe boating and support the CCGA. It's a lifesaver.
You're watching TVNB, the New Brunswick channel.
And after 20 minutes of play, St. John Flames lead the St. John's Maple Leafs 2-0 in a period absolutely dominated by the St. John Flames. Oh, shot them 12-3. Barry, no question, they came out like a house on fire. They want the W tonight.
Well, like I said during the broadcast, to those that are listening on TVNB, Jamie Hodgson's really fighting the puck here tonight. It's hitting him all over the place. He's looking around for the rebound. He can't find it anywhere. He goes out to play the puck. He can't play the puck. He just has no puck-playing skills once that puck comes down around behind the net.
Well, like we said, Jimmy White suffering from a case of vertigo. I mean, he did play last night and played an outstanding game between the pipes. But they want to get this kid some work because they know that those long road trips are coming up. And they've got to count on him to be able to get in there. But he's not getting too much help from the blue liners either. They're really letting him get hit with a lot of rubber. Like we said, outshot 12-3 in the first period. I think the Leafs going into the locker room really have to put a conservative effort into where the defense is tonight.
Take a look down the other end of the ice. Levent Super, he's going to be really cold coming out in that second period. Now you look at the other end, Hodgson, he's going to be nice and warm. He's getting lots of shots. Goaltenders like a lot of shots. You may see Hodgson pick it up a little bit more as the game goes on through the second period. But Super's probably thinking, you know, come on, D, let a couple of shots go in there. Let me, you know, handle a couple. But the ones he has handled, he's been quite sharp on them.
Well, the Flames are just smothering things up in the neutral zone and not letting the Leafs get a chance to get set up. You saw in the later half of the period, the Maple Leafs were starting to put things together and figure out how this defense was set up, but just a period totally dominated. A couple of names from the Flames just a run by. Varlamov came flying out of the gate in that first period. Someone lit a fire under his butt because he's been playing well, but he's playing exceptionally well tonight.
Well, he's wearing contact lenses that say Calgary on the inside of them. None of us can see that, but that's where he wants to be. Mark Burrow playing a pretty good game because that's where he wants to be. He's not much, he hasn't had much taste of the AHL. He's not, he doesn't like it down here too much. He wants to be back up in the NHL. Can't blame him. I mean, why not, you know? That's what you strive for. Varlamov's playing a great game. Bada, if Hodgson keeps playing the puck the way he is, Bada's going to burn him and burn him bad and burn him several times if he doesn't start playing the puck better. And the only thing is the Flames in the first of the period, I don't know if they had nerves or what, but they were coughing up the puck left and right, and it's a wonder they're not down by a score of 2-0.
Absolutely, it could be that way very quickly. Speaking of Bureau, we had the cameras down to Harbor Station earlier this week and caught up with Mark, and here's what he had to say.
Kind of hard to accept, but I mean, you gotta, when you sign your contract, you gotta go with what the rule said, and I had to report here and see what's gonna happen. Right now, with all the everything's going on around the league, especially at the beginning of the season, it was a tough situation because everybody got their full club and everybody's looking at what they're gonna need, and we're here to work hard and keep the shape, and we'll see what's gonna happen.
Do you have any regrets about the way your career has gone, moving from Montreal to Philadelphia and that sort of thing? Do you see that helped or hindered your development?
Well, it was kind of different because in Montreal I was kind of used like 20 minutes a game, checking big lines and killing penalty. And I got that contract when I was a free agent, offered by about four or five teams, and I chose to go to Philly. And I knew that going to Philly, my ice time would be reduced with all these center they had there. But it was a a point that I had to try, and I don't regret to went to Philly, except that maybe my ice time went down in the last 2 years. And at the end of the season, when they traded me to Calgary, there was the same organization that was there when I was in Calgary 13 years ago. And at the end of the season, everybody was fired, and they brought new management. And I guess it didn't feel the same need that they thought. So I guess they didn't need my services. So it was one point that they sent me down here, and we'll see what's going to happen in the next few weeks or few months.
Do you have any idea how long you're going to be in St. John, and what do you think of the new regime in Calgary?
Well, you know, it's a new era on lots of points, and it's a different conference playing in the West and in the East, and I don't know what they decide to go with it, but here, you know, like I came here to work hard, and we'll see. Like I said, we'll see what's going to happen in the next few weeks, but. Coming here, they got a good bunch of guys and a good coaching staff, I think, and I come here to help the young guys on some things maybe they need to, and like I said, we'll see in the next few days, few weeks.
We thank Mark Pietro for his time earlier this week. Like you said earlier, Barry, you know, just recently sent down from Calgary. He wants to go back to Alberta. There's no way he wants to stay here too long. And the way he's played in the first 20 minutes, he's making a good, strong case for himself.
Well, I think he is, and he knows it. But he knows he's got to really show his stuff down here in St. John before he can go back to Calgary. He was really disgruntled that he came down here. Almost refused. Actually, if I remember correctly, he did refuse for a little while to come down here. He finally agreed and said, well, if I'm going to have a shot at playing in the big leagues again, I better go down. Because a lot of these guys remember what happened with Yashin and you know, a few others that decided to hold out, and it doesn't really work too much in their favor.
On the injury front for the St. John Flames, probably the most notable from last night, Steve Bajan just absolutely got sandwiched between two Leafs defensemen, and they thought at first it was a separated shoulder, but you had a chance to talk with Aaron Kennedy, of course, who is the beat reporter for the Flames now, and that doesn't appear to be the case.
No, I think he's just a little tender, a little sore in the muscle, and it may, they did some x-rays, Aaron said, and that didn't dislocate, so obviously just a little tender in there. There's a little sack in there called a bursa sack, and that might have got sandwiched a little bit, and that can be pretty painful sometimes. So hopefully, you know, the Flames want him back. He's only a little guy, you know, he's 6 foot, but he's little compared to the average height of the NHL, and he's not afraid to take anybody on. As you saw on our broadcast last week, he took on some, I can't even say his name now, so
He was a big Swede. He had to be about 6'4", just huge, playing for the Scranton Penguins.
And Bajan didn't back down. Aaron Kennedy says, this guy won't back down from anything. Aaron said, do you know what you were doing? And he says, it doesn't matter. He says, I'll take them all on, big and small. He said, it doesn't matter to him.
Kamikaze hockey, you're going to get it here at Harbor Station from Steve Bajan. They hope to get him back in the lineup, hopefully, when they begin their road trip, which comes up later this week. Had a chance to chat with Derek Walzer earlier this week. Let's go to the tape and see what Derek had to say.
I think it's going to be a lot different from the teams last 2 years. We're going to have a better coaching, a lot younger team. I think more enthusiasm coming to the rink every day, so hopefully we'll put a good product and a good show on the ice for the people that support the team.
The coaching change seems to have rejuvenated you. Do you like it better this year than last year?
I just appreciate the opportunity. He's given me a chance to play, and he's letting me play my game. Even when I make a mistake, he's putting me back on the ice, and he's giving me some more confidence that Rick Wyatt ever gave me. So I'm just going to try to take advantage of it right now.
You expected some offensive production is expected from me, I guess, this year. Do you relish that role, or do you rather be defensive defenseman?
Well, I'm not very, very big, so I gotta put some numbers up on the offensive side, but I also gotta play well defensively, so hopefully it's gonna work both ways. So if I can help the team with a good defensive game or a good offensive game, I'll take a step at a time.
You played all of your junior, I guess, in the Quebec League, did you not?
Yeah, I played and started out at 16 in Quebec City, and then I got traded to a small town in Rimouski, who ended up winning the Memorial Cup last year. So I liked my 4 years in junior in the Quebec League, and I wouldn't change a thing.
You must be quite adaptable. That's a bit of a culture shock to a guy from Glasgow, Nova Scotia, to go to Quebec for 4 years.
Well, everyone says it's hard, but I mean, I went to a team. We had 8 bilingual guys and 2 fellow Maritimers 1 year and 2 the following year that came up. So, I mean, it was pretty much easier. It just took a little bit of time getting used to the restaurants and the families. But after that, I mean, I thought it was pretty easy. And they're, Quebec is so open. They're so nice. It's something I recommend someone else to do in the league. Just like the Stanford kids go on the mountain. A couple kids have gone to Victoriaville. So hopefully they're learning the same way I did, and they appreciate what they're learning.
What do you have any particular goals for this year for yourself or for the team here in St. John?
Well, I just have a personal goal is to stay here the whole year and hopefully not get sent down to Johnstown, just to work hard and have no regrets at what happens at the end of the season from my point of view, and the point of view of the team. If we go all the way, we go all the way. If we go to the second round, I just want to know that I put everything I got into the season and hopefully it becomes a plus side instead of a negative side.
Right, you'd be happy with being a full-time AHL player. What about the other way, going up to the NHL? What are the prospects there?
That's something that's out of my control. All I can worry about is my control. Staying in good shape, working hard, and playing well down here. And if you get the call, you get the call. If not, at least you know you're doing your best you can.
And thanks very much, Derek Walzer, for his time earlier this week. Walzer is—he doesn't look like a hockey player. We were mentioning that we were looking at the interview. I mean, he looks more like a Ken Dryden type player. I mean, we all know how great of a player Ken Dryden turned out to be, but very conservative player. But when he's out on the ice, gives his full A-plus effort all the way.
Well, like any hockey player, once that jersey goes over their head, altogether different ball game. Once the blades hit the ice, it's an even different ball game after that. But it kind of turned into a Jekyll and Hyde type of thing. And a lot of these guys do that. And usually the tough guys are kind of like that, eh? Off the ice, they're real pussycat. On the ice, don't mess with them because they're not a guy to mess with.
Absolutely. That's been a lot of talk around the station. You just walk around Harbor Station tonight in the last couple of games. St. John really doesn't have a tough team out this year. There's not a lot of strength. There's not a big player out there who probably stand in front of the net, poke home a few rebounds, or let one go off him and try to get a couple of those good effort goals. So what does this team have to do? Are they going out to look for somebody, or are they pretty pleased with what they've got right now?
I think, Jimmy, personally, they got to go out and start looking, and they got to look hard because Royer, as Aaron Kennedy also told us before the game started, he's out. He's been out since February with a bad knee, and I have a bad one myself, so I know those things never heal. They just never seem to heal. They're like a back. It's always going to be nagging and nagging and nagging, and I don't know. I think they have to go out there and look for something, someone, and I don't know where, but they got to go down maybe to the East Coast League, shop around a little down there. You know, he doesn't need 30 minutes a game. All he needs, you know, is 10 minutes every once in a while. Things get a little rough like they did here last night. Bada got thrown around. Tkachuk's getting thrown around. You know, and these guys are getting frustrated here tonight. You can see Bada, he's jabbing, he's poking, he's jawing. And these guys can't be doing that because that's taking them off the game, which is what the Leafs want to do here, or any visiting team wants to get those guys off their game. And I don't know. You see Dave Rose out in front of the net in the power play or even at even strength. That's his job. You know that's where he's going to stand and hopefully get a deflection. And he caused some interference on Fata's goal tonight, and that was Fata's first goal of the season, which is a shock, really, because they played four home games already, and he hasn't gotten a point yet. And, Roche really caused a lot of interference in front of Hodgson. Hodgson couldn't really focus on either Roche or Fata to the side of the net. He stuck with Roche, and he paid for it.
No question. Last game we did, we rode Rico a little hard because he just simply was trying to do too much, I think, on his own, and that was kind of hurting the play. And like we said, he's probably, if not the fastest skater in the AHL. He's just unreal to watch when he breaks down the wing. And the way he's setting up the play tonight, it's almost like Jimmy Playfair took him aside and said, look, you know how fast you are. Drop it down a notch. You can keep up with the boys. You want to put the burst of speed on, you get a chance for a breakaway, do it. Keep the hot dog, save it for practice. When you're out there, utilize those other four players that you've got.
There's one time in the season when Fata can really put on that show. That's around the 40-game mark of the season. It's called the All-Star Break. That's where you put on the show. That's where you wow them. You're on national TV. Do it then. Don't be doing it, 10th game into the season, 5th game into the season. That's not the time to do it because you've got a bunch of rookies in there. They're going to be wanting to follow some of these guys, so they're going to start trying to hot dog a little. But you see Fata out there with Varlamov. You see him out there with Bureau. You see him out there with Tkachuk. Looks real good. And you got Roche in front of the net. Looks even better.
Well, it's a great lineup so far for the St. John Flames. They lead 2-0 after 20 minutes of play, outshot the Leafs 12-3 in the first period. Second period action with Barry Johnson and Steve McDonald coming up here on TVNB.
With so many choices, why stay with cable TV? Well, let's see. Cable means reliability, quality, and more channels than ever. It also means digital services like commercial-free music, plus internet connections much faster than a phone line. It also means guaranteed service and installation. No ugly satellite dish, no extra receivers to buy, no extra antennas, and no missing out on local channels. Kind of a no-brainer, isn't it? Cable TV. It's really smart. This remarkable moment brought to you by your family. Isn't it about time?
Thanks.
The V6 will give you plenty of power for the size of this minivan.
It represents their past.
Ship Mondays at 7:30 and Thursdays at 9:30.
UAP Napa. It's the right brand for the job.
TV used to be so simple. Now you have more choices than ever. Satellite TV, wireless systems, even the phone company. Seems like there's a new one every day. But when it's all said and done, nothing beats cable. And now with digital cable, I get more channels than ever. Even local channels that I don't get with satellite TV. Plus music and internet connections much faster than my phone line can provide. Cable TV. It's really smart.
Hard facts or just coffee shop gossip? Hot Topic lets you tackle the important issues in your area. Live, Wednesdays at 7, only on TVNB.
We're kind of making this up as we go, you know.
She is, yeah. Can you folks smell it at home?
Carrie's Kitchen, Tuesdays at 6:30 and Thursdays at 8:30, only on TVNB.
Action. I'm Steve McDonald along with Barry Johnston. And Barry, see you made your way back up into the broadcast booth.
Double duty here tonight, Steve.
You're a busy man, my friend.
Oh, very busy, very busy.
Obviously, we're glad to have you aboard with us for tonight's broadcast. It adds a lot of comments to the game, and I'm a firm believer that two is better than one.
Well, I've seen the Flames from day one and been on the inside of things a little bit in their first couple of years that they were here. Good friends with Brian Batapi, the head trainer when he was here, and really enjoy following them.
Action has resumed here in second period. Flames have it inside of their own blue line. Bringing it up now, Daniel Tkachuk in control. Tkachuk weaves a path up towards center ice. Tkachuk on the back end has to turn around. Mayer doing the forechecking for the Leafs, hems him in. Now Tkachuk loses an edge but bounces back up. He'll bail out this time and hands it off to his teammate. Scoville sends one over to the open side for Clark. Clark gets it up as far as the league blue line, where it's picked up by Dempsey. Dempsey inside of his own blue line now, has to try to do it all over again. Both teams scurrying around here in the early stages of the second period. Tkachuk still without a helmet. As Dempsey in over the line, fires one. That's redirected up over the top of the net into the open corner. Clark takes his man out onto the boards. Mayer looks at him with a little bit of disgust, didn't like the way he was taken down. Scoville now in control. They'll bring it up over the blue line. Near corner, cross-ice pass goes all the way into the boards. Tkachuk again, still without the helmet. Feeds it off back behind the Leaf goal. Clark out in front. Oh, low shot saved by Hudson. Goal! Who was that sneaking in from the point? I believe it was Mike Martin.
That it was. That was Mike Martin in there, left all alone, sitting in the slot area. And poor Hodgson just didn't know what to do. Martin had one whack at it, then he got the second whack at it, and he beat Hodgson on the short side. Now the Flames lead by a score of 3-0.
And for Mike Martin, his second goal on the season. But wow, that was a dandy as he caught everybody sleeping. And again, Hodgson made the original save, but the rebound, as we talked about earlier with Hodgson tonight, the rebound came right out, and again, not a soul around, and Martin not going to be denied. He makes it a 3-0 lead for the Flames. Back to the faceoff circle now. Derek Walzer has it for the Flames. He'll lob one into the open corner. Racing in there. Fata, two-team back behind the goal. Still manages to keep the puck. Fata lifts the opposition player stick. Now the Leafs have it. They'll bring it up the right-hand side. Pass right up the center. Long shot. That's easily gloved by Zupper. Zupper going to leave it for the goal scorer, Mike Martin. Martin sends it over to Mike Bureau. Bureau on the right side, goes to the left side, puts it right onto the stick of Roche. Roche, taken into the boards. There was one of the Flames forwards. I believe it's Clark.
No, it's Rico Fatta down there on the ice. He took a hard hit. And we see Sutherland's going to call a boarding call here.
Fatta now gets back up onto the ice. That's a good thing because that was definitely hitting from behind. And the physiotherapist, Ryan Miller, goes out to Rico Fatta, but he comes off on his own steam, so it looks as though he's going to be okay. And the Flames on the power play. But that was a vicious hit.
That was the call, 2 minutes for boarding.
And he's lucky he only got 2 minutes.
Assist on that goal, Martin's goal, went to Tkachuk and Clark at the 109 mark of the second period.
So Clark picks up an assist. That gives him 5 points on the season. And for Tkachuk, his second assist to go along with two regular season goals. Now the goaltender, Jamie Hodgson, down doing a little work on his blade. And as a former goaltender, I did that a couple of times just to get a little bit of break, take the heat off.
That's just buying time for your players that are out there.
The faceoff deep inside of the Leaf blue line in the near corner. A 3-0 lead. For the Flames. Off of the draw, puck comes back to the point, right onto the stick of Scoville. Cross ice, DuPont fires one high over the top of the net. Puck remains in the corner. Clark takes a little tap back down the boards, gets it to Alomo. Alomo sends it back to DuPont. Cross ice pass to Scoville. Scoville takes a little time, puts it back across, and it squeaks out over the blue line as it was a little too far for DuPont. Now DuPont at center. Taps one in over the Leaf blue line. Hustling in, Graton. Takes it all the way into the boards. Clark comes in to help him out. Gives a little bit of room. Leafs try and get it outside of their blue line. Kept in at the line, though, by Scoville. Scoville fires it all the way back behind the goal. DuPont back at the point. Over to Scoville, near side. Shot again. Redirected into the corner off of the skate of Mayer. Flames applying the pressure. Puck comes back. Scoville back to Alomo. Alomo wanted to tee up. Decided not to. Now he'll get another chance. Top of the circle again. Blocked by Dempsey this time. And Elise get it down the other end, bringing it in. Travnicek taken out on the boards by Scoville. They'll tie it up. Alomo comes in to help out. The referee wants him to move the play along as there's three Flames on that puck. But Travnicek manages to hold his ground and will have a faceoff.
That was a real good play by Travnicek, trying to get the, you know, whistle down in the other end, buy a little time, kill the clock, and you know, he did his job. And the faceoff coming deep into the Flame zone to the right of Zuber, who is really, you know, not tested. He hasn't got a shot yet here in the second period, and 2:59 has gone by in the second period.
46 seconds left on the power play. Leafs have the puck inside of the Flames' blue line on the face-off circle. That draw, though, won by the Flame. They'll take it back behind their own goal. Pass up to Tkachuk on the left wing. Tkachuk takes it in over the line, gets around one man, back to the top of the slot. Shot, Martin again. And this time it's stopped, and the goaltender Hodgson going to hang on as there was a couple of Flames right in front.
He had a couple of Flames where one was Fatta and the other one was Roche, who was standing in front of the net, and Hodgson did good that time to hang on to the puck, and I think they may have been talking to him after the first intermission and saying, look, you know, you're bobbling the puck a lot, you're not covering up those rebounds, you're giving up too much, and you're going to get burnt.
Faceoff deep inside of the lead blue line in the far corner. Tkachuk to take the draw. Up there against the Hackinson. Hackinson wins that battle. Puck goes back behind the lead goal, though, into the hands of Dave Roche. Roche tried to sneak one back for Tkachuk, a little too far for him. And the Leafs lob one down, and that goes off the glass into the stands. So we're going to have another stoppage of play and a faceoff still inside of the Leaf blue line. 16:33 left here in the second period. The Flames lead by a score of 3-0.
Martin's been a house on fire in this period alone. He's got three shots, and we're only 3 minutes and a half into the second period. So this guy, keep an eye on him for tonight, because he's obviously a force to reckon with here tonight. He defense finding that puck, and as a defenseman, you don't usually see that too much, but hey, do what you got to do, and he's doing it right.
I still can't get over how much time he had in front of that net with not a soul around. Back to the action, no Flames. Bring it back. Walzer has it just inside of his blue line. Long pass to Roche up the left wing. Roche tickles one in there for Fata. Fata back behind the goal. Drops it back to the point. Here it comes again for Walzer. Walzer streamlines one all the way through everybody. Fata the recipient. Fata drops it into the corner. Roche back behind the goal. Trying to get a little bit of havoc from the Leafs. Now the puck comes across. Tkachuk taking it on the boards by Hackenser, or by number 43. And that's Chad Allen. Allen races over to the loose puck, tried to drop it out of the blue line. Now he'll get it there, and the penalty has expired, so both teams skating it five aside, as that one's going to be ruled a offside, so we'll have another faceoff, this time just outside of the Leaf blue line.
Well, the Flames got 15 shots on goal right now, and things seem to have settled down a little bit. The Leafs are not coughing the puck up as much. The Flames have really settled down since the first part of the first period, where they were really coughing up the puck. Everything, both teams settling down and just finding the groove right now, and looks like it's going to be quite an entertaining hockey game for the rest of the way here.
Kharlamov, blackout on the ice along with Benoit Gratton. And number 19, Botterill. Leafs trying to get a little bit of room inside of the Flames' blue line. Puck goes back behind the Flame goal. Morozik eludes a check. Puck comes right in front of the goal. That's picked up though, Morozik. Up over center ice, one hand on the stick, brings it in, gets around the defense, looks towards the front of the goal, that's redirected into the back of the corner. Hustling in is Gratton. Gratton drops one all the way back to the point for Montador. Montador fires one, that's redirected. I think Botterill got a piece of it, but it just goes into the open corner. Now Gratton on the backhand, up close back behind the goal. Gratton feeds one to the top of the slot. That was intended for Varlamov, and the Leafs will pick that one up. They'll get it up as far as center ice. Now they'll tap one off the boards. Picked up by the Flames inside of their own blue line. Morozik can't get anywhere, so he just jumps it down the ice. He'll go for a line change. On comes big number 28 again, Dave Roche. That comes all the way back behind the goal. St. Croix back to pick it up, and we're going to have an icing call. 14:40 left here in the second period. Flames lead by a score of 3-0. And Barry, the pace up. The bases, the pace of the game so far is keeping fairly consistent with the first period.
It is. It's from about the, I think maybe the 10-minute mark part of the first period, things have really been just kind of staying the same. The Flames really put on a lot of pressure in that last rush, and it looked like a 5-on-4 instead of a 5-on-5, but the Flames, they seem to be cycling the puck well down low, and a lot of communication out there. Bata this weekend, I should say, doesn't seem to be showboating, I guess you could call it, dancing around with the puck and whatnot. That's for the All-Star break. That's not for this time of the year.
But a face-off shot there from the point. Hudson makes a save. Puck goes cross. Fata puts it right in onto the stick of Bureau right in front, and Hudson going to hang on as the Flame forward standing right on top of him. And of course, that's going to call a little meeting in front of the goal.
Well, they don't really want to wake up Dave Roche too much because he's a gentle giant out there, but if you light his fuse, I think they better stand back because he can get pretty fiery out there, and he's been pretty calm the last few games, so he's a guy that they maybe needs to be woken up a little bit, but he was standing right on the doorstep, but the defensemen were doing their job trying to get him out of there, and not letting any rebound get past Hodson there tonight.
And don't forget to join us in the postgame show for the Dominion Refuse Garbage Goal of the Game, brought to you by Dominion Refuse and St. John Recycling. Together we can make a difference, and that's always an interesting setup. Face-off deep inside the league blue line. The Leafs win the draw. They'll take it all the way in the corner. Now the Flames pick it up inside. Fata still pushing away, trying to get a little bit of room. Leafs, though, manage to bring it out of their own blue line up the right side. Farkas in control. And now he's not in control as the puck was eventually sent in off of the stick of Travnicek. Flames at the face-off circle, tried to squeeze one in front. The Leafs almost got an opportunity, but here comes Dave Roche up the left wing. Roche fires one. That goes back behind the goal. Fata cruises in there, overskates the puck. And that allows the Leaf to get control. Now Fata picks it back up again, back behind the goal. Fata stops, looks one way, goes the other. And maybe one move too many as the Leafs swing it back out towards center ice. Hackenson sends it over, all the way in over the line. Shot! Zuper reached out as far as he could. Good thing, because the puck was just off the outside of the post. Mayer chips in from the back now, tries to throw a check, misses him, and that was Dave Roche. That one was intended for. Now Roche comes to the player's bench. On comes Alomo. Leafs, though, in control. Thornton has it. Thornton, stop there. Alomo tries to pick up the loose puck. Now St. Croix going to tie up Thornton in on the boards. Alomo comes in to try and help him out. Leafs working very hard, trying to get an opportunity. St. Croix knocked that one out of harm's way into the open corner. Now Alomo uses the boards to get it up as far as center ice. Tkachuk streamlines across, tried to take out his man, but it's Elise. Again, a lot of center ice hockey right now, Barry, as both teams very undecided as to who's going to be the aggressor. The only one that seems to be is Sean Thornton. And Thornton just can't get anywhere as the Flames dump it all the way back inside of the Leaf blue line. The goaltender Hodgson out to pick it up. Shot! Oh, and a save there, and I believe that was made by the defenseman as Tkachuk looked as though he had a wide open net. Leafs come back the other way. Can't get it inside of the zone. Now here comes Tkachuk again. He'll hand it off to Alomo. Shot. Hodgson gingerly just sends one into the open corner. Alomo races in to pick it up, as does Tkachuk, and Tkachuk takes out Alomo. And Alomo, the puck underneath him. Referee wants him to get up and get play going. So now the Leafs have control inside of their own blue line. They'll make their way up to center ice. Cooper over the line. That shot fired low and wide. Comes all the way around the backboards. Flames pick it up. Graton in control. Graton had to wait. Clark picks it up. Sends it across back to the point for Martin. Martin can't bring it over the blue line. Here comes the Leafs again. They'll get a little pressure inside. Wrist shot. Blocker saved by Zuper. Going in the corner. Ponikarovsky ties it up. Now they'll bring it back behind the goal. Again, they're going to try and tie it up and get a whistle. As the referee right there wants them to try and move it. They do. Puck goes under the stick of House. Bobby House sends it in back behind the goal now. Hackinson tries to fire it away. Can't do it. Puck goes back behind the goal. In comes the Flame defense. They'll try and tie it up on the boards. Walzer ties it up. Now they'll try and get a whistle this time. They do. 11:23 left here in the second period. 3-0 Flames lead. We'll be right back. You're listening to Home Hardware Flames Hockey on Country 94. Dempsey as Zuber got the right leg down, and the puck will come all the way down the ice, and we'll have an icing call. So 11 minutes 12 seconds left in period number two. Barry, the Flames up by a score of 3-2, but the pace is staying par for the course.
Yeah, the Flames up 3-0, and Zuber's only faced his fifth shot of the game, second shot of the period, and he's made a couple of good saves. He made a nice blocker save, and then that last rush he made a nice pad save. He's on his game for somebody who's only faced five shots, and that's kind of hard to keep warm, keep into the game. He's got a lot of idle time down there, and Hodgson's been the busier of the two, but he's not been the more successful of the two with a score of 3-0 for the Flames.
Flames get the face off, but they have to come out to center ice to pick it up. Back is DJ Smith. Smith cross ice pass now. Farkas picks it up. Farkas tried to send it across the other side for number 18, Kalmakoff, but he'll be ruled offside. And again, as a goaltender, I know for sure that when you get into the game and you don't get any shots for quite some time, you're always worried about having to make that crazy save where you can pull a muscle, stretch a groin, or whatever. So obviously, Zuber are going to have to keep busy, even though sometimes or most of the time the play is out in center ice or inside of the league blue line.
Well, obviously, he's staying focused because when he does get shots, he's been able to handle the task when it's been presented to him.
Off the faceoff in neutral ice. Now Flames inside of their own blue line. They'll put it up towards center ice. Good play as Bata tees that one off. They'll try and get it to the front of the slot. Now Roche has to play one into the open corner. Leafs will pick that up. Off of the glass, back behind the boards. That's going to come all the way down to center ice. Good check there by Dave Roche, but he's going to be nailed for that one, and he's going to go to the penalty box as he laid a Jeff Farkas thrown on the ice, but again, the penalized player, so now the Leafs will go on the power play.
Dave Roche going off for interference at 9:23, I think it was a pretty good hit, but the puck was nowhere near Farkas. And Dave Rose, I think, trying to fire things up a little bit by throwing a big hit. One guy who's trying to throw the biggest hit of the game out there, I think, is Brad Maher. This guy, he's going to either hurt himself or hurt somebody else very, very bad out there, because he's really been trying to throw a big hit out there. And he's caught a few people. He's getting closer and closer all the time. But one of these times, I don't know if he's going to take somebody's head off or if he's just going to take his own off and miss. But nonetheless, we'll keep an eye out to see if he does throw this big hit that he's looking for.
So the Leafs on the power play. Flames, though, have it at center ice. They'll just take a few seconds, pause for the cause, and then lob a high one down the ice. The goaltender Hodgson comes out to play it. He'll leave it there for Nathan Dempsey. Dempsey, again, logs a lot of ice time, especially on the specialty teams. Flames, Clark can't get it outside of his own blue line, kept in by the Leafs. House, top of the slot, shot saved by Zuber. Got that again, the right leg down. And Zuber on top. He'll have to be on top again. Another shot as Zuber stretched all the way out. The shot was wide. Puck comes back to Dempsey again. Dempsey fires one towards the goal. Clark going to try and pick up that loose puck. Clark ties up on the boards. Kept in, though, by Bobby House. And now the Flames again try to get it out. Can't do it. That shot partially blocked by St. Croix. St. Croix trying to tie up his man in the corner. That allows the Leaf to get it to the open man. House again puts on the brakes. No doubt he'll try and send one back. He's going to try and find Dempsey. House now, and elects to go into the corner. They'll drop it back to the point for Cooper. Cross-ice pass shot saved by Zuber. And Zuber just shovels that one into the open corner. But the Flames right now can't get it out. But thank that rubber puck for going over the glass, because the Leafs had all the pressure on the last 15 seconds.
The Leafs have been trying to beat David Cooper on the power play, because he's got a bullet of a shot. Anybody who remembers him from 2 years ago, that's who the Flames tried to go to all the time, was to him on the point, because he's got just, like I say, a bullet, a rifle, whatever you want to call it. And the Flames know that, and they've been trying to keep the puck away from him, and they've gone to Dempsey quite often, and he's got a pretty hard shot, and Zuber was up to the task for it and really handled them quite easily.
So the faceoff again inside of the Flames blue line near corner. They'll get it back to the point. And Nathan Dempsey right now, 4 out of 7 shots for the Leafs. So he looks to be the go-to guy. And the Flames now squeak one down the center. 22 seconds left in the Leaf power play. Leafs back on their own side of their blue line. Tyler Halton. Center ice pass right onto the stick of Farkas. Farkas brings it in over the line, couldn't corral it. And now DJ Smith will have to hustle back into his own zone. As the penalty just about expiring, the attacker back out on the ice. The both teams skating at 5-a-side. Leafs bring it in over the blue line. Puck comes back to Helton. Top of the slot. Shot there. That was weak. As Nemirovsky got a piece of it, but didn't get good wood. Now the puck comes back again. They'll try and send it towards the front of the goal. The Flames doing a good job of keeping the front of the net open. Here comes Nemirovsky again on the backhand, sweeping around the faceoff circle. Nemirovsky in front, saved by Zuber. And he was definitely ready on that one. And in front of the goal, Jeff Farkas ties up with a Flame player. But the linesmen get in real quick, so there'll be no damage done.
You said a key thing there. The Flames are clearing out in front of the net. Zuber's been able to see the puck. He's been able to stop it, obviously, every time now. He's faced 8 shots, and 5 of those have been in this period. And he's just doing a great job out there. He's at the right place at the right time. He's covering all the angles. He's only a small guy. You know, he's not the biggest player on the ice by no means. But he's doing the job well, covering all the angles. And he's keeping the Flames in it here by a score of 3-0 with 8:12 left to go in the second period.
But again, a big game here at Harbor Station. In case you've just tuned in, I'm Steve McDonald along with Barry Johnston. And this is Home Hardware Flames Hockey on Country 94. And a 3-0 Flames lead so far this evening. Face off inside of the Flames blue line. Morgan Warren to take the draw for the Leafs. Warren manages to get it back to the point, right onto the stick of Allen. Allen takes it all the way back behind the Flames goal. Warren comes in to try and help out. They'll try and squeeze it out in front. Puck goes into the corner. Clark picks it up for the Flames. Clark rubbed out on the boards. That'll give the Leafs control. They tried to turn it back and hit Warren with one. Warren got a piece of it. Puck goes all the way back into the corner. Walzer back to pick it up. Eric Walzer gives it to Montador. Montador just moves it up ice. Here comes Alomo racing in to try and split the defense. Can't get there in time, so the Leafs will have to hightail it into their own corner. Now they'll send it up the left side on the center ice for Morgan Warren. Warren puts it in the blue line, goes in himself to pick it up. He's kicking out on the boards by the Flame forward. They'll try and tie it up on the boards. Now here comes the Flames. Pass right on the Tkachuk stick. Another pass sent over there, and I believe that's Botterill. We'll have to wait and see. Swing around shot. Puck in front. Puck's going to come back to the point. It'll come all the way out, though, to center ice as Alomo gets back up on both wheels. He'll go to the bench. On comes Botterill. Breton racing in. Hodgson. Botterill sends one out towards the front as Hodgson out of his goal. Had to be careful there. Flames now put it deep into the corner. That's going to go under the stick of Breton. Breton can't get anywhere, so the Flames will have to go back their side of center ice. Scoville. Scoville has that one go off of the skate of Travnicek. Now the Flames. Breton dumps one into the open corner. Bata also comes in to help out. They'll try and get it towards the front of the net. Bata puts it back behind the goal. They'll try and send it out in front. Bata, the recipient, can't turn around in time, so the Leafs will pick up the loose puck. They'll put it up to number 18, Kalmakoff. Kalmakoff way offside, so Travnicek going to have to wait. Now Travnicek tries to bring it in. The bouncing puck just continues to bounce, and the Leafs just send it up to center ice. Kalmakoff can't get anywhere. He'll send it in. Super makes the save, and he's going to hang on. And again, a little bit of a scraggly play in the last minute or so.
See Graton, John, a little bit with the Riviere down there, and Graton was the recipient of a slash right at the blue line. Fans were calling for a penalty there, but Sutherland did not see it and therefore could not call it.
Well, the Riviere doesn't get a whole lot of ice time, but I know in the Quebec Major Junior Hockey League, he was a nasty, nasty boy, as he plays a rough and tough kind of game and takes the odd penalties, but he's not scared to drop them if he has to. Played with the Moncton Wildcats, and then I believe he went on to the Rimouski Oceanic.
That he did. He played three seasons in Moncton, and then he was must have been traded, I believe, to the Rimouski Oceanic.
And of course they went on to win the Memorial Cup last season in Halifax. Flames keep a little pressure on now. They're still inside of their own blue line, though. They'll try and squeeze one up onto the stick of Roche. He can't get anywhere, so the Leafs just dump it back inside the line. Walzer, the defenseman for the Flames, picks it up. Walzer sends it up to Roche again. Roche, cross-ice pass, shot! See, a score! Hodgson might have got a piece of it, and Marc Bureau gets his first deal goal in the AHL and gives the Flames a 4-0 lead. So for Marc Bureau, his first American Hockey League goal.
And that's what the Flames need to get from this guy. They need to get him scoring. Maybe that'll get his confidence going. Maybe he'll start putting the puck into the twines a little bit more. Hodgson, I think, thought he had that. Looked like it from our angle. Looked like he might have had it there too. But unfortunately, he didn't for his sake. And the puck just dribbled down over the red line. And now the Flames lead by a score of 4-0. 5:26 left to go in the second period.
And we'll be right back here listening to Home Hardware Flames Hockey on Country 94. Second period action. Flames lead by a score of 4-0. Marc Bureau getting that last one At what time was that at?
14:34, assist from Roach and Graton.
So Roach and Graton pick up the assists on Bureau's first goal in the AHL. Playing, or Leafs rather, have control at center ice. They'll send it across. Kalmakoff tries a rifle one intended for number 35, and that was Antipov. Couldn't pick it up, so the Flames swing it back down the other way. At center ice now, Montador lobs one into the Leaf corner, goes to the bench. On comes Scoville. Flames still have it inside. The Roche in front, shot off of the stick of number 25, Graton. Graton couldn't get anywhere, so the Leaf elect to just bide some time, send it back. Varlamov had to be careful there as one of the players, I believe it was Travnicek, had him lined up. Needless to say, puck back in behind the Leaf goal. Trying to set something up. Travnicek, the centerman, wants to get a little bit of room. He's hightailing it down the other side. Look for the sleeper. And the Leafs, again, trying to get out of their own zone. Good forechecking by the Flames. And that one's going to be whistled down.
The high stick there, just inside the Leafs blue line. Defenseman tried to knock it down with a high stick, but something like that had nothing to do with that, so he called that, and we're going to face off just beside the Leafs blue line.
And I see Sean Thornton making his way out onto the ice for the Leafs.
I think he's fire is boiling through his veins right there now. I think he's going to try and get his team fired up. He's got Dave Roche and Thornton lined up at the faceoff. You know Thornton's talking to him. I think Roche might have been shaking his head a little bit, saying no. There's Thornton trying to get him to go.
Yeah, that's what they were doing. Sending out the invitations. Right now, nobody's taking. Play at center ice. Back for the Leafs. Picking it up, Morgan Warren. Sends it over for Thornton. Thornton gets rid of the puck right away. Dwyer Betts out on the ice. Now Walzer takes a hit from Thornton. Puck just lays inside of the Flames' blue line. Now Walzer has it. Knocks that one out of the air. Gets it up to center ice. Lobs an easy one in. Thornton running around trying to hit anybody he can. Meanwhile, the Flames out in front. That one there almost sent off of the, into the open corner by Kenny Kurup. Now Kurup comes back to the bench. On comes Bureau. Bureau just tags one into the open corner, and the Leafs have to hightail it back into their own blue line. Back to pick it up is Tyler Helton. Helton puts on the brakes behind his own goal. There comes Thornton now. He makes his way up ice. Throws an elbow towards Botterill. And the Flames turn it back the other way. Long shot. That sails just over the top of the goal. Comes all the way back to the point. Morozic shot saved by Hudson. And the puck just goes back behind the goal. Bureau back to pick it up. He'll send it to the top of the slot. Drop pass back to the point. Didn't work. Hustling back is Mickey Dupont. And Dupont sends it back up to center. Puck, Botterill feeds one out into the open corner. Thornton, again, just looking for anybody as the puck goes up over the glass. And now I believe Thornton's going to go to the player's bench. And again, on the way to the bench, takes a little hack and whack at Mike Martin.
Thornton's just really trying to get things going here for his team, but he's going to cost his team, I think, in the end here if he doesn't stop. He could have been guilty of a high stick. He could have been guilty of an elbow. There was a lot of stuff there that Sutherland could have called on him, but he's just at the right place at the right time. We got a correction on the Flames' fourth goal. It was assisted by Kurup and not Graton. So that was a correction. If you're scoring at home, it was not Graton, it was Kurup.
Face off inside of the Leafs corner in the far corner. Kachuk to take the draw against Hackinson. Now Hackinson waved out of the face-off circle, so in comes Bobby House. Number 27. House again, 5 goals, 5 assists, 10 points so far this season. Weak shot from the point. Hudson makes a save. And the Leafs now, Hackinson, long, high pass, knocked out of midair by his teammate, but it's the Flames who pick it up inside of their own zone. Now it's stolen off of his stick by number 23, and that's Ponikarowski. And Ponikarowski can't get anywhere, so the Flames just send it down to center ice. Now here comes Kachuk in over the blue line. Stops, good play. Hudson makes a save. Rebound comes out in front. And the Leafs breathe a sigh of relief. They'll put it right back down ice again. House has that one go off of his stick into his player's bench. And again, we'll have another face-off, this time just outside, I believe, of the Flames' blue line. 1:09 left in the second period. Flames on top by a score of 4-0.
Leafs are going to be on the power play here, Steve, with 1:09 left to go in the second period. Going to the penalty box is Chris Clark, 2 minutes for holding, for hooking, sorry. But he 18:51, Clark is going off for hooking. That gives the Leafs a chance to get on the power play with only 1:09 left to go. And that's when something you want to start the third period off with the Leafs onto a power play.
Never give the other team any, and I repeat, any kind of ammunition, because it'll come back to haunt you sometimes.
Once again, you got David Cooper playing on the left defense. You know why he's out there, and that's to get that shot off. You got to get some traffic in front of Super, and the Flames have been doing a great job of that, clearing the front of the net, and for Super and able to see the puck.
Hero wins a draw, sends it all the way back inside of his own zone. St. Croix tried to flip it out over the line, can't do it, kept in by the Leafs. They'll send it into the corner. Puck comes back, Farkas drops it all the way back to the point for Cooper, saved by Zuber. Puck just lays there, Nemirovsky sends it out in front, where is the goalie? The puck comes across the open crease. Leafs again scrambling around, they'll manage to keep it inside the line again. Farkas goes to the backhand, puts it onto the stick of Mayer. Mayer can't pull the hammer, they'll drop it all the way back to the point again for Cooper. Long cross ice pass, Farkas tried to pull the trigger right away, but he had the safety on because he couldn't get the shot away. Now St. Croix back behind his own goal. Euro tries to get a little bit of room, can't get anywhere. And again, the Flames this time rip it around the other side of the boards. Fata goes a nice play on the backhand, and he finds the other end of the ice. Martin now comes onto the ice with Morozic and Botterill. And the other player for the Flames still out there. He's bringing in over the line. Now the Flames chuck one up ice as time expires and the second period has come to a close. And at the start of the third period, the Leafs will still have a power play for 50 seconds on the penalty to Chris Clark. So after 40 minutes of play, the St. John Flames 4, the St. John's Maple Leafs 0. We'll be back. Let's go right now back to Brent Moore for this sports update.
So simple. Now you have more choices than ever. Satellite TV, wireless systems, even the phone company. Seems like there's a new one every day. But when it's all said and done, nothing beats cable. And now with digital cable, I get more channels than ever. Even local channels that I don't get with satellite TV. Plus music and internet connections much faster than my phone line can provide. Cable TV. It's really smart.
The V6 will give you plenty of power for the size of this minivan.
It represents their past.
Ship Mondays at 7:30 and Thursdays at 9:30.
UAP Napa. It's the right brand for the job.
Hello, I'm Brian McLean, host of This Week. Every Friday at 6 and Sunday at 5:30, we look at the top stories from across the province.
Daniel? Am Großvater und ich haben genau das Gleiche gemacht. Das hat meine Pflichten viel leichter gemacht.
Wasser, die Lebensquelle ist Land.
Ottawa asks us to design a pump for the third world.
International Development said, lightweight, rust-proof, so simple you could fix it with a rubber band and a bent nail. I said, with today's technology, no problem. Well, maybe today's technology is the problem.
So?
It was in our own backyard. Mennonite resourcefulness, eh?
She says you Canadians have such modern ideas.
Tell her it's really a very old idea.
Welcome back to Harbor Station, where after 40 minutes of play, the St. John Flames totally dominating the St. John's Maple Leafs 4-0. Saw a little burst from the Leafs there when they are on the power play. They're going to be back on the power play for 50 seconds heading into the third period. And I'm telling you, Barry, they look like they're asleep out there.
They look like a minor league team out there tonight. They're not playing very good hockey. You never know. They scored 3 goals last night and played a rather competitive hockey game. But I don't know, maybe the second game in 2 nights, a little hard on the legs, maybe a little too hard during practice in the morning skate this morning, but nonetheless, Sean Thornton, near the end of that period, tried to get Dave Roche to go. Dave Roche shaking his head no. He could see it from up top where I am. And Thornton just went out and he whacked everything in sight. He was coming to the bench. He whacked another guy. He's just trying to get his team going. He wants to scrap with somebody just to try and get the momentum on their side and get things going. They're going to have a power play for 50 seconds coming into the third period. They got to do something with it now. Do it early, and maybe they can carry it.
Well, not exactly a bad strategy by Thornton. Like you said, he's trying to get the momentum on their side. The Flames are totally dominating that neutral zone. They're blocking the holes up, not giving the Flames, they're prowling, not giving the Maple Leafs a chance to set. And that's exactly, Jimmy Playfair has got to be saying to himself, this is what I've been preaching in practice. This is what I've been writing on the chalkboard. This is the way I want you to play.
This is why you guys skate for 2 hours hard, you know, every day of the week, pretty near.
You bet.
And you can't say enough about Super. Great call on Playfair's behalf so far tonight. I think Super needed to get the start. He needs to get this W under his belt. He's got to get his confidence. 5'11", I think that's a little on the generous side. I think that's the blades on, possibly. But the Flames, I must say, are doing great on defense. Clearing in front of the net. Super's getting to see that puck. Golden can see the puck. There's no reason why you can't win a hockey game.
No, absolutely not. And, you look at Hudson. How much longer is he stay between the pipes where the Maple Leafs are in a situation where Jimmy Waite's suffering from a case of vertigo. So chances of seeing him tonight, I don't even think he's dressed tonight. So you won't see Jimmy Waite between the pipes. So you look at Zuper, and there's a kid, first kid ever to be drafted out of Finland. So that's an honor in itself right there.
I'll correct you on that one, Jim.
Hungary. I'm sorry about that. But then you look at, he really hasn't faced that much rubber tonight. But like you said, to get that first win where they're going on a long road trip, and they've got to get him between the pipes, get him to see some rubber so that he's not stone dead cold. And you brought up a good point in the first intermission that he didn't face too many pucks. So how strong was he going to be in the second period? But he's looked sharp so far.
Well, he's faced 8 shots in that period. A lot of them good quality shots, especially early on. He got the blocker on one. He got the pad out on another. Sticking the glove out. But like I say, the defense are clearing the zone. That's what they got to do. And they're doing a great job of it. We see David Cooper out there, which a lot of fans around here are kind of laughing and chuckling to themselves. David played in Germany last year, came back to the pro ranks, signed on as a free agent with the Leafs. He's out there basically only on the power play is where I've only really seen him. He's been out there off and on. But the reason why he's out there in the power play, he's got one bullet of a shot. He's got probably about near the hardest shot. You can compare him to an Al MacInnis. Really.
Yeah, oh, absolutely.
He's got that long stick, straight blade for near. There's just a slight little hook on the end of it. But he's got a great shot, and that's why they got him out there. They try to beat him, but the Flames know that guy's got a shot. Ivan Boudreau and those guys that are scouting around, Ivador's up top, they know they're keeping David Cooper covered like a wet blanket. Really, that's what they're doing. They're not letting the puck get out to Cooper.
One of the criticisms about the Flames going into this game was two, actually, not enough offense and not getting enough quality shots on goal. They were drilling pucks at goaltenders but weren't able to put it on net. No one there to grab the rebound, take those good second and third efforts, but tonight, that's simply not the case.
Well, they need to get a win here tonight. They need to get those shots. They need to do something because they're playing back-to-back games against Hamilton. They're trailing Hamilton right now for third place. The Leafs are in second. You got to get the win tonight. That puts you near tie with Hamilton. And then you're going into Hamilton's barn for back-to-back games. Then you come back here and play the Leafs again on Friday night. So they got to get this win tonight, carry the momentum to Hamilton, get at least 4 out of 4 anyway. If not, get a split or a 3 out of 4. But don't come out of here. Don't go out of Hamilton with nothing.
No, absolutely not. Flip over to the NHL just real quickly, of course, with the Leafs here in town. Everybody, the building is abuzz about Toronto and the slow start they've gotten out to the gate. 500 teams so far right now, but they play a tough game in Calgary tonight. Curtis Joseph, he's been playing well, but the offense once again has been struggling. Defense hasn't really been playing that well. What do they have to do to turn things around? They spent a lot of money in the offseason. Gary Roberts in there. They have switched the lineup around a little bit. Roberts is now playing with Sundin. That really seemed to spark them in Edmonton the other night. The Oilers no slouch this year out of the gate. So, do they turn things around? The Western road trip is a brutal one. No one likes to take it, but they've really, I mean, Leaf, there's a lot of expectations going into this season with Toronto.
Well, Toronto, you know, they had a good run last year. You know, the near made it, you might as well say. You know, they almost did it, but I don't know. Going into Calgary, I think Calgary, they can't say Calgary, they got young players, young guns. That excuse can't be used anymore. It's a no-no.
Oh, absolutely.
I mean, their defense, a couple of years ago, yeah, they were young.
Yep.
Now they're not so young. They're getting older, more experienced. Denny Gauthier logging a lot of ice time up there. You know, Gary Roberts, I mean, that's a guy that retired here a few years ago, and now he's back playing. At any given time, his career, his life almost could be over. He maybe never walk again, because with a neck injury, he could get a good check, you know, hit from behind, anything at all. He could be out for his career. What Calgary has to do, I really don't know. But they, like I say, they just spent a lot of money. They really drove hard to try and keep their ticket sales up, to try and keep the team in town. So now they got to really ice the team. It's hard to do in a Canadian market because you're competing with that American dollar.
No question about it. Speaking of young guns in Calgary, of course, one of the brightest young guns down here in St. John is Rico Fatta. And we had a chance to catch up with Rico earlier this week, and here's what he had to say.
Let's start with the fact that you are coming back here for a third season. I'm wondering, of course, about your frame of mind, because when guys get sent back from the NHL camp, sometimes it takes a while to readjust to the minors. How is it for you?
Oh, well, obviously, you know, you want to do well, and you want to do well right away. And I think in my case, and I think everybody else's case, is you got to relax a little bit, and you got to understand that things just can't happen right overnight. So, you know, we played 5 games already, and we're just going to have to look at it every game by game, I guess.
If you look at Craig Button, the new GM in Calgary, do you sense a change in philosophy, if that's a proper word to put it, or new regime compared to the old regime?
A little bit. You know, they're always stressing, you know, hard work and, you know, everybody, you know, driving the net, one guy going to the net, one guy not going to the net. It's a new philosophy, like you said. It's a new system. There's a lot of skating involved, not only in the offensive zone, but back checking and stuff. So there's a lot of work involved for our forwards, and our D-men are just kind of hanging back and hanging loose right now.
Rico, tell us a little bit, though, about your personal goals of making the NHL Flames. Did you think that after 4 seasons of Calgary missing the playoffs and the kind of campaign you had last year in St. John, that this was the year you would be ready to make it to the NHL full-time?
Well, I always wanted to. You know, there's, you know, I'm going to training camp. You know, you train all summer to work hard. Come into training camp in good shape. That's just probably one aspect of it. But you're thinking, like, a lot of things that you did accomplish last year playing in the NHL, you're thinking that maybe you can make that jump. And it's always tough coming down to the minors and everything. But you got to look at it stride and stride in, and it's tough. But hopefully, like I was saying to Aaron Kennedy, that we can look at it as, 6 or 7 years down the road, hopefully, when I look at my career, that it did really help me a lot to come down here and play.
Well, I know when he was here in Moncton, Brett Hull told us that he thought it was a great experience, reflecting later on when he went to St. Louis and scored all those goals. But Rico, specifically, what do you think it is that's separating you from making it to the NHL full-time?
What I was told, and I think what I've been really concentrating on these last little while, is consistency. And it's going to probably show over the course of the year that you got to play well every single night. And it's definitely tough to do it night in and night out when we're playing 2-2 and we're playing 3-3 and long bus rides, like you guys mentioned before. And I think consistency and being committed to my own zone is going to help me get there.
Do you think the coaching change in St. John, does that help or hinder you in any way, shape, or form as to the quickness? I mean, a coaching change sometimes can change your role a little bit, but do you see a new coaching change as kind of a new start for you to maybe speed the process up a little bit more?
Well, we got all new coaches in Calgary as well, and new coaches down here. You know, Jimmy and Dog have been doing, you know, a great job with us. They've been, you know, going over video with us and showing us exactly what, you know, what we're doing wrong and what things we're doing right. So it's a good situation down here for everybody, not only me, but for a lot of young guys and even, you know, some of the older guys that are working hard to try to get to the next level. And it's good to have them around. They're very personable, very good coaches, and I'm very happy to play for them. It's enjoyable right now, and I just want to try to keep it going.
Rico, when you look up and down the St. John roster, tell us what you like about this edition of the Flames when you pick out some of the strengths.
Well, we definitely have a lot of speed on our team. You know, just to mention a few new additions, you know, Mika Alomo, he can motor, and Blair Betts was the second round in 1998, who's wanted to make a name for himself. And we got a guy that's playing really well right now, and that's Kenny Krupp, who's come in and you know, turned some heads and surprised a lot of people. And, you know, it's good for him. He scored 30 goals last year in the OHL, so he's looking at trying to keep a roster spot all year. And, you know, we got those three guys just to mention, but, you know, with Martin Brochu, the list goes on. I think the guys are going to really gel together in these next little while.
Rico, they're talking speed, and some people seem to think that sometimes you have a little bit too much speed to catch up to yourself. Do you think that's a problem at times?
It could be at times. I think that's the main thing about my game is knowing when to jump on the puck and knowing when to skate with the puck with, you know, full steam, and when to change my speed up. And that was the big thing on me in training camp, where I would. The coach would tell me, you know, where to go and how to be and read the game. So I got to read and react to the type of situation it is.
Rico, a year ago you had Fata's Funhouse cooking there at Harbor Station. What's exciting about this season? Are you doing anything like that?
I don't know yet. I haven't decided. It took me a while to get things going last year. You know, I really enjoyed it. I thought the kids really enjoyed it. I really enjoyed it. It was fun. I got to meet, some great fans that would come to the game, and they would be ranting and raving after the game, and I put on a couple pounds for all the pizza I ate.
But don't you think, Rico, with the experience you had with Fata's Funhouse, do you see athletes like yourselves having that responsibility to be a role model to our youth?
Well, everybody's a role model on our team, no matter what, because we're in the paper. You know, you're walking around town, you know, people notice you, and people notice what you do. And we're pretty much under the microscope all the time. But I don't think anybody's really obligated to do anything. It's rather your choice whether you want to do something. I just wanted to do something. I never really got into that kind of stuff. I did a little bit with the Children's Hospital in London, Ontario, with my junior town. But I thought it'd be a good chance to give back a little bit and give some kids an opportunity to see some of the games.
We thank Air Maxwell and Air Allen Power for that interview with Rico Fata, right winger for the St. John Flames. 4-0 Flames lead, 20 minutes left to go. Barry, what do the Maple Leafs have to do to even try to make it look like they want to get back into this game?
Well, at least go out there and play, that's for starters. But they got to go create some offense, get some communication going, get talking to one another. I mean, your D's not talking to the forwards. The passes are going all over the place. They just got to help their goaltender, get some defense out there. Maybe they got to throw David Cooper out there. I don't know. But they just got to do something. And needless to say, we're going to find out in about 2 minutes' time.
All right, we look forward to it. Third period action coming up from Harbor Station. You're watching Primetime Sports on TVNB.
With so many choices, why stay with cable TV? Well, let's see. Cable means reliability, quality, and more channels than ever. It also means digital services like commercial-free music, plus internet connections much faster than a phone line. It also means guaranteed service and installation. No ugly satellite dish, no extra receivers to buy, no extra antennas, and no missing out on local channels. Kind of a no-brainer, isn't it? Cable TV. It's really smart.
For plenty of tips on healthy eating for you and your family, be sure to watch Healthy Bites each week here on TVNB.
The V6 will give you plenty of power for the size of this minivan.
It represents their past.
Shift Mondays at 7:30 and Thursdays at 9:30.
UAP Napa. It's the right brand for the job.
TV used to be so simple. Now you have more choices than ever. Satellite TV, wireless systems, even the phone company. Seems like there's a new one every day. But when it's all said and done, nothing beats cable. And now with digital cable, I get more channels than ever, even local channels that I don't get with satellite TV. Plus music and internet connections much faster than my phone line can provide. Cable TV. It's really smart.
Hard facts or just coffee shop gossip? Hot Topic lets you tackle the important issues in your area. Live, Wednesdays at 7, only on TVNB. Enjoy a vigorous workout from some of New Brunswick's most beautiful locations. Cardio Energy, Monday, Wednesday, and Friday at 5.
And again, that's one of the reasons why they lead this game by a score of 4-0.
And just to bring you a note, Mike Martin, plus 3 on the plus-minus scale so far this evening. So again, Mike Martin doing a fine job, and he picked up a goal tonight, his second goal of the regular season, which at the time gave the Flames a 3-0 lead. And very nice to have you back on board again, LeMoy. We're getting ready for third period action.
Thank you very much, Steve, and catch my breath here, and we'll be able to do some talking.
Right off the opening faceoff now. Leafs have it inside of their own blue line. Puck goes over to DJ Smith. Smith fires one up the other side. They'll wrap it around the back of the boards. In doing the forechecking, Ponikarovsky can't get it. Now Ponikarovsky will pick it up. Ponikarovsky, again, just feeding it back and forth. Euro tying him up on the boards. Puck comes to the point. Smith can't get a hold of it, so the Flames just try and send one outside of the blue line. Euro took a wave at it. Can't get it. Now the Flames will lob one all the way down. As, of course, 15 seconds left in the lead power play. As the penalized player gets back up and ready to get back on the ice. Leafs over center ice on the right side. They'll drop it in front. Ponomarowski can't get anywhere. They'll just tap it back behind the net. That'll go to Hackinson. Hackinson still back behind the goal. Penalized player back out. Puck comes out in front, and that's Clark. Clark will pick it up on the feed. Good pass there as he shovels it right up ice. He'll bring it in over the line. Shot saved by Hudson this time. As Hudson, another shot that's redirected. Kachuk tries to race to the front of the goal. Can't pick it up, so the Leafs scurry around in their own zone. Hackinson has it. Hackinson uses the boards to try and feather one up towards center ice. He does. And it'll go into the hands of the Flames. Flames again bring it in over the line. Kachuk goes to the top of the slot. Tries to feed one through the crease. It comes all the way through, but there's only Leafs around. Now the Leafs send it up towards center ice. As Clark takes his man out, and that's Matt House. On the puck now, Chad Allen has it. Allen goes to the backhand on the right side of the boards. And that goes up over the glass. It's going to have a stoppage and play. 18:23 left in regulation time. Flames lead 4-0.
I should also mention the NHL, the Leafs are leading Calgary by a score of 1-0. That's still 13 minutes left in the first period. Toronto trying to get something going here after a mediocre start this season, and I think they need it because there's not much down here in the farm, as we see tonight, to call up. But nonetheless, the Leafs had a good game last night, and you're entitled to a bad night, and tonight looks like it's going to be their bad night.
And again, Steve Bajan out of the lineup tonight with a shoulder injury. Expected to be back in the lineup next Friday. Square off again right here at Harbor Station.
Russell mentioned tonight, Steve, in attendance with Grant Fuhr.
Had the opportunity to do an interview with Grant last night, and it was an awkward position for me because Grant was one of my heroes when I was growing up in the frozen ponds back in northern New Brunswick. But a good interview, and Grant had a lot of good information for the fans. A long, long, proud career. Back to the action. Flames have it. They'll bring it in over the blue line on the far side. Botterell scores! Jason Botterell wires a good snapshot to the low cross side. And it's now Flames 5, Leafs 0.
Well, the Flames are definitely on a route here. They're going to just really embarrass the Leafs here altogether. Score 5-0 with 2:07 gone in the third period. We may see a goaltending change here. It's hard to say, but I don't know. Maybe they're just going to leave Hodgson in there and suffer the brunt of all this. But to save a lot of embarrassment, I think maybe they should haul Hodgson out of there and save a little bit of pride of what he's got left.
Again, a tough night at the office, but you have to hand it to the Flames. They're really picking the corners and using the most of their opportunities. A 5-0 lead now for the Flames. Again, face off at center ice. Kulub has it. Kulub back in outside of his own blue line. Metz couldn't pick it up. That'll come with a hand to the lease. And we lost it. Puts one towards the front of the goal. And now the Leafs will have to go back inside their own blue line. Allen back there behind his own goal. ...17-26 left here in third period action. Long pass, that's going to go all the way down the ice. And I believe we'll have an icing call.
That's Lane's fifth goal coming from Botterill, and it's just going to Graton and Morozic at 2:07 of the third period. Now it's just a great, great rush down the ice by Botterill, and he made no mistake about it. He fired a snapshot to the blocker side, and he beat Hodgson. Hodgson also cannot be blamed for tonight's 5-0 score so far in the game because he's got no defense in front of him.
Again, a bit of a switch from last evening, but again, the Flames really taking the play to the Leafs. And again, that's what Jim Playfair wanted. He wanted a total team effort tonight because it is an important game.
Especially with Hamilton leading 2-1, I believe.
Back to the action. Leafs have it inside at center ice. They'll take a long shot. That goes wide into the corner. Back to pick it up is St. Croix. Now the Flames inside of their own zone. Move it down to center ice. Alomo has it on the right side. We're going to have a penalty being called. And I believe it's going to the Leafs number 21, Nathan Dempsey. As he upset the apple cart, and that was the Flame forward.
Be a high sticking call to Dempsey at 3:09. That's just not what the Leafs needed right now, but that's just showing a little bit of frustration that things aren't going their way and they're starting to take some bad penalties.
Still waiting for John Thornton to get onto the ice this period. Hasn't made it so far, but now the Leafs going to be shorthanded. The Flames on the power play. And Rico Plata out there along with Dave Roche, Daniel Tkachuk back at the point. Number 24, Darryl Scoville, and number 3, Steve Montador. Right off of the draw, Fata has it just inside of his own blue line. Rico Fata turns around now. He's going to drop it back to the point to Montador. Montador takes a deep breath. They're going to wait as Fata wheels around. Here comes Montador. He'll spot Fata on the right wing. Fata in over the blue line, shovels one towards the goaltender Hodgson, and he's going to hang on because there's two white shirts right out in front of him.
When you got Tkachuk and Roach right on the doorstep, you're not going to let anything go, and he's been doing that too much tonight. He had the chance to smother it, saw it, and he smothered it up to get a face-off to the left of Hodgson. You see, Tkachuk and Fata out there, they played a lot together last year. Great duo to play, to have out there. And then you got, of course, Dave Roach, who's going to go right to the net after this puck is dropped.
And Tkachuk, no doubt, trying to get it back to Montador. Now they'll whistle that one down as the referee, Kelly Sutherland, ruled that there was a little bit of a quick start on behalf of one of the players. They'll do it all again. 1:35 left in the power play. 16:27 left here in the third period. Flames on top by a score 5-0. Tkachuk at the faceoff circle. This time it's won by the Leafs. And they'll tallywhack one all the way down the ice. Goaltender Zuber comes out. He's just going to play that there and leave it for Steve Montador. Montador with Scoville back at the points. Now Montador again gives it to Rico Fata. Fata in over the blue line. Dave Roche makes his way towards the front of the goal. They're going to drop it to the point to Montador. Montador tried to give it to Scoville. Scoville couldn't pick it up. That's intercepted by Ponikarowski. Ponikarowski, long shot. Zuber makes an easy blocker save. Puts it right onto the stick of his teammate. And that is Tkachuk. So Tkachuk brings it up the left side. Now he weaves his way up towards center ice. In over the blue line. Good feed. Sends it across. Fata fires one high on the shoulder of Hodgson. Puck goes into the corner. Roche back behind the goal on the backhand. Gives it to Rico Fata deep in the corner. Fata eludes a check. Pushes it up the line a little bit. Stopped at the point. Now on the back end, they'll try and send it in front. Pass across. Oh, they were looking for Fata on that play. As now there's a big scrum in front of the goal. And I don't think there will be any damage done. We'll be right back. You're listening to Home Hardware Flames Hockey on Country 94.
Yeah.
32nd. Flames power play. They have control inside of their own blue line. Martin out there again. He's got one of the goals tonight. They'll have to regroup. Start it all over again. Walzer has his pocket pick. Here's Tulis in all along. Goes to the back end. Saved by Zucca. As he got that glove up off of number 23, and that was Ponikarovsky. And Ponikarovsky shaking his head. Flames, meanwhile, send it back in the other way. They'll try and jumpstart something, but now Tulis. I like to dump it down the ice as their penalized player comes back on. But what a save by Zupar.
That just goes to show what kind of a night the Leafs are having. They just can't even put one on them on a 2-on-0. But though, he had look at what kind of a night Zupar's having, too.
That's why I've been calling him Super Zupar. All he needs is a little playing time. Back to the action, though. 14:34 left here in regulation time. Flames in over the Leaf blue line. Betts tries to send one into the corner. Now Betts has to hustle back. Tries to take his man out. He's the one that goes down, gets back up again. As the Flames elect to just dump one down the ice. That should go all the way for icing as Allen's going to touch it. And we'll have a face-off back inside of the Flames blue line. Now I see Sean Thornton over there talking to, I believe, Blair Betts.
That's it hit Thornton right in front of the Flames penalty box. And I think Thornton thought maybe that was an invitation to loosen up the gloves a little and see what can happen, but I don't think Betts going to have too much to do with him tonight.
Faceoff will come all the way back inside of the Flames blue line to the proper side of Levin Super. Oh, now they move it over to the blocker side, so again, the faceoff still inside of the Leafs blue line, 14:15 left here in regulation time. Morgan Warren getting a lot of duty at center, taking these faceoffs. Thornton out there, along with number 24, LaRiviere. LaRiviere on the left side, and Thornton on the right. Puck comes back to the point. Allen, cross ice pass to Cooper. They'll send it back behind the Leaf goal, but it's the Flame goal, rather. Clark picks it up. Long pass, way down to the stick. Lomo tried to bring it in over the line, but the linesman already waved it down.
Good call by Tim Skinner there. He had one foot over, and the puck just wasn't quite with that foot. Had to call it down. Should mention that Morgan Warren, one of the few Maritimers in the game here tonight, Summerside and PEI native.
With the Moncton Wildcats, the Q.
Yeah, I remember watching him quite often playing down there, and quite a nice player to watch play. You know, he does quite well, and good to see, you know, some Maritimers getting noticed and, you know, getting into the pro ranks.
Actually, he's one of the guys that the coach of the Leafs, I talked to Lou Crawford, said that this is one of the guys that has to learn not just the tricks of the trade, but has to learn the trade and then pick up the tricks.
That's right.
But he's got a lot of confidence in him, and he said he's going to bring him along nice and slow, and he foresees a good pro future for Morgan Warren.
The kid's got good size, 6'1", 193 pounds, so that's pretty good qualities right there to be in the pro ranks.
Back to the action. Leafs in control at their own side of center ice. Coming onto the ice is Varlamov for the Flames, but at the Leafs, fire one towards the goaltender Zupar. He'll hang on to that one, and now again, a little bit of nastiness in front of the Flames goal, but I believe the linesmen are going to get in time.
Seems like every time we mention nastiness or anything going on, Thornton's in the mix of things down there. So I think the Flames know that they can get under his skin and get him to draw a penalty, and I think that's what their tactic is right now. But Thornton's keeping his head in the game, and a lot of us have seen him lose his head a few times. But
again, he hasn't drawn a penalty, so Thornton out there doing his job. He just can't jump start the rest of his teammates. That's the only problem they're having. Faceoff in the near corner. Leafs win the draw. They'll get it back to Smith. Smith fires one. That's blocked in front, though, by the Flame forward. Coming in is Varlamov on the other side. Pass across. Shot fired just wide, I believe. That might have been Botterill. Botterill now back behind the goal. They'll tie it up in the corner. Botterill races around to the front, trying to get a good handle on it. Puck goes into the corner. Graton couldn't pick up the loose puck. And the Leafs will get it down as far as center ice. Mickey Dupont back to pick it up. Hands it over to Morozic. And Morozic just lobs one back behind the Leaf goal. DJ Smith gets it up as far as center ice. That's going all the way down. So again, we'll have another icing call. But this team, the Leafs, tonight anyway, look a little bit dejected.
Well, that's to say the Leafs. I mean, they're down 5-0. losing in the shots department too, 28-14, and there's still 12:49 left to go in the third period. But though yet the Flames are really not capitalizing on some of the chances they do have. I mean, the Leafs right now are really asleep, I guess is the only way to put it, and the Flames should be really just all over them, should be filling that net. But nonetheless, I guess Hodgson, you can say we've been down in him a little bit of the night here, but he has been keeping them in the game as much as he can.
And again, the Flames today had an optional practice, while on the other hand, the Leafs out in full force going through their regular drills. Off of the faceoff, puck comes back to the point. Martin sends it back behind the goal. Hustling in now, top of the crease, shot fired, that's blocked in front. That comes off of the stick of Karup. Now the Leafs pick it up, can't get it out. Martin manages to keep it in. Leafs again try to get it out, this time they do. Farkas tried to get somewhere, now he can't. As the puck comes all the way back behind his own goaltender, Chad Allen. Broken stick on the ice, creating havoc for the Leafs, but they managed to send it inside of the Flames blue line. Back to pick it up though for the Flames is Martin. Martin puts one into the open corner, shot there, fired wide, and the Leafs again will get control. Allen up to Farkas, back over to Allen, almost intercepted by Rico Fatta. Now Bureau knocks that broken stick over to the boards, at least to get it out of the way. Leafs swing it back, Farkas in over the blue line, shot blocked in front. Leafs still keep control though. Allen Rook tried to fire that one away. Botterill now picks it up at the near corner. Back pass by Fatta into Botterill. Can't pick it up. And the Leafs swing along one back. They'll send it up right onto the stick. Mrazek. Mrazek can't get anywhere as he'll fire one across the front of the crease. Shot there off of the stick of number 26. And that's Rourke. No damage done. And the Flames get it back to center ice. Bureau just dumps one into the lead corner, goes for a line change. On comes Tkachuk, along with Alomo and Clark. Clark turns it around at center ice, gets it back to his defenseman. And that's number 24, Scoville. Leafs again. Alek to just tap one off, and that hits someone in the stands. And she seems to be okay.
Got to keep your head up here, even in the stands, not only on the ice, but up in the stands too, because that puck in come off the ice at fast speeds. Game kind of just taking a little bit of a turn here, slowed down quite a bit. Of course, we are almost to the halfway point of the third period, and you know, the Leafs just kind of saving grace here, I guess you could say. You know, they're trying to keep it so that's only a 5-0 game, and on the other side, the Flames are trying to fill the net, but nonetheless, super. Can't say much more about him. He had a few quality shots. He's had 15 in the game so far. And I don't know, the Flames had an overall good effort here tonight.
And again, tonight's 5 goals scored by the Flames, their highest output so far this regular season. In their 8th game. Back to the action, 10:51 left here in the third period. The Leafs take one, they'll send it in. Halton shovels one all the way into the open corner behind the Flame goaltender. Now it comes off the backboards, and I believe we're going to have a penalty, and it's going to Morgan Warren, I believe, of the St. John's Maple Leafs, as Warren makes his way to the penalty box.
Looks like he's getting a roughing call there. He doesn't look too happy about it, but nonetheless, he's going for 2 minutes at 10:41 of the third period. And this is another power play that the Leafs just cannot afford to give up right now. It's just... The Flames are just going to capitalize on this and make it a 6-0 game.
And again, Morgan Warren was just trying to go around Mickey Dupont, and he was a little too forceful. So Dupont said, hey, I can get you into a penalty, and that's exactly what Dupont did. And they will have a 2-minute power play. Off of the faceoff now, Flames again on the power play. Dupont can't get anywhere. Had that one foiled by Adam Mayer, but again, the Flames send it all the way into the corner. Roche knocked down. And he goes tumbling into the Leaf goal. Roche will try and score from anywhere. And Hodgson, the goaltender, very smart and quickly get out of the way as he saw Roche coming in. So again, they'll have a face-off here. Now the fan noise meter, he is making his way up. Trying to get a good crowd on hand tonight here at Harbor Station.
Not a big crowd that they'd be expecting, but nonetheless, it's a good crowd here tonight, and probably near the same amount as what was last night, 3,500. And the few that are here, they're into it. The Flames are winning by a score of 5-0. So, nonetheless, it's a good night. It's a great night for the Flames to head out on the road. They play two against Hamilton, and they're back here against the Leafs again. Hamilton right now by winning by a score of 2-1 against Albany, so they need to keep pace with Hamilton in order to keep close to the third place in the Canadian division.
Off of the faceoff, Dubois sends one into the corner. Blair Betts out there, along with Kenny Karup. Karup tried to get it to Betts, but the Leafs intercept, and they'll put that one over the head of Mickey Dubois all the way back to the goaltender, Levin Zupar, and Zupar just leaves it for Chris St. Croix. St. Croix now weaves his way up, hands it over on the right-hand side. They'll put it into the corner. Betts hustles in there. Hudson, the goaltender, comes out to play it. That'll be stopped at the point by Dupont. He'll go to his left defenseman. Back to the right side again. Shot locked in front. Karup sends one back behind the goal. Betts sends it back to the point again. Back to Dupont. Dupont top of the slot off of the skate of Blair Betts. Now the Flames still trying to get something going. Roche takes his man out. And the Flames trying to apply the pressure, looking for that good shot. They'll fire it away, intercepted. Leafs now managed to squeak it out to center ice. Now Antipov comes on the penalty kill. 36 seconds left in the Flame power play as the puck just goes to the goaltender, Hudson. And Hudson going to hang on, and we'll have another faceoff.
Flames want to consider themselves lucky. They're not playing shorthanded themselves, because Roach has been called for holding, hooking, mauling, whatever you want to call it, because he just yanked down his player and his man, and Sutherland neglected to call that, and also right just inside the Leafs blue line there was a high stick there that should have been called, but nonetheless Sutherland kept the whistle down and kept the arm down, kept the whistle in the pocket, so to speak. And Flames are still 5-on-4 with 33 seconds left to go in the power play.
Hero giving out orders to his teammates on this faceoff in the far corner. Giroux wins the draw, gets it back to the point. The monitor shot saved by Hudson, and look how much he came out of that one, out of his crease to make sure that there was no rebound. And that's the farthest out of his crease I've seen Hudson tonight.
And the reason why he didn't go for rebounds was because he got caught in his equipment. So it was an altogether good play by Hudson. Morozic, I know, would have loved to have been. Was it Morozic? Took the shot. I think he would have loved to have been inside there just a little bit farther before Hudson had a chance to get out. Actually, it was Mondador, that took the shot. But Hudson covered all the angles, and there wasn't a chance for Mondador to really pick a corner anywhere.
And again, Bureau basically told Mondador he's going to try and get it back to him again, so let's see what happens. That was a planned play. Try and give him a little bit of room. Mondador gets the puck. Now he's got to swing it across to the left side. Back to Mondador again. Now they'll put it in for Fatta. Fatta shovels one into the corner. It'll come back to the point to Mondador. He fires one. That goes wide. Hustling over there now is the forward, Varlamov. Can't get anywhere. They'll try. Fatta squeaking in on the boards. DJ Smith trying to pry that puck loose because the referee won't allow them to tie it up. There's a broken stick, I believe, down on the ice.
Stick belongs to Bureau.
Mark Bureau lost his stick as the penalized player back out onto the ice, and now both teams skating at 5-a-side. Leafs realize that, so they'll move it up to center ice. Antipov gets it in over the line. Puck there, wide shot, saved by Zupar.
Just a great save by Zupar there. He was just left all alone to fend for himself, and I believe that's Morgan Warren, I think, has a shot there. And just couldn't put it by him. I mean, this Zupar is just covering all the angles, and he's just not giving them anything to shoot at all.
And again, that's one of the differences tonight between Zupar and Hudson. Hudson having trouble with those shots as far as corralling them, keeping them inside his body, and Zupar just not letting any rebounds back out. So again, he's eliminating a lot of headaches by freezing the puck as soon as he gets it, not allowing any rebounds. 8:26 to go, 5-0 Flame lead. Face off inside of the Flames blue line from the trapper side of the goaltender, Levin Zupar. Off of the draw, Chris Clark takes it into the corner. Long shot from the point. Zupar going to make the save off of the stick of Rourke on that weak shot. So an easy save by Zupar. Shot clock creeping up just a little bit. But again, the Flames with 30 and the Leafs with only 18.
Zupar's had no trouble handling the 18 shots that he's had, but just enough to keep him in the game. great goaltender, staying focused. He's following the play quite well. And I think the Grant Dorr here in attendance tonight, I think he'll have a good report to send back to Calgary on this kid. And he's picked a good night to put on a good performance, nonetheless.
Again, now back to the action. Puck comes back to the point. Shot! Zuper got a pad on it somehow. Puck comes back out, and the Flames will pick it up. Alomo hands it over to Tkachuk. Tkachuk just sends one into the open corner. Hackinson waits for a feed. Too far ahead of him, so the Leafs just bring it back up again. Dempsey tries to do it all by himself. And Zuper uses the boards to put the puck out of harm's way. Now the puck still stays in the corner. They'll try and fire it to the front again. The Flames intercept that pass, and they'll bring it down nice. Alomo brings it in himself. Now he hustles back to the bench as they make a wholehearted line change. On comes Betts, Botterill, and number 26. They'll send it back. Here comes number 26 again for the Flames, and that's Karup. Karup in on the right wing. Tries to send it all the way into the corner. Blair Betts in to help out. Broken stick out on the ice as Karup has to let go of it right away. And now he's drawn a penalty as Karup trying to get to the bench just to get some new hardware. But whether he knows it or not, he's just drawn a lead penalty, and the Flames will be on the power play. 7 minutes, 6 seconds left here in regulation time. Flames lead 5-0. We'll be right back. You're listening to Home Hardware Flames Hockey on Country 94. Play as the penalty going to number 43, Chad Allen. 2 minutes for tripping. And the Flames inside of their own blue line now, 5-on-4. They lead this game by a score 5-0. Puck comes up on the right hand side. Dupont gets it in over the line. Big Dave Roche out there also. They'll try and feed it towards the front of the goal. Tkachuk drops it back to the point. Shot! That's redirected. Just goes wide. Hustling in now. Dupont tries to keep it in. Roche sends it back to Rico Fatta. He looks left, goes right. Fatta, again, a crafty little wizard. Oh, takes it all the way back to the point. Now he dumps it inside and makes his way toward the front. Dupont scores! Mickey Dupont. Fatta was the feed. And I thought that play was going to Rico Fatta, but Mickey Dupont was the setup guy. And he just hammered home a snapshot between the legs of the goaltender Hudson. And now the Flames lead is a half a dozen, 6-0 on the power play.
That was a real nice goal by Mickey Dupont. He waited, skated into the spot, and he just let a real nice trickler go in. That is Mickey's first goal of the season, and I know that he's quite happy tonight to get that first goal. Every player, when they come to the pro ranks, like to get that first goal, just to get the monkey off his back. You know, they feel a little more comfortable after that. That was a real nice goal, showing great patience by the rookie, and he just waited, skated into the slot, and let it go.
A big 6-0 lead here with only 6 minutes, 23 seconds left in the third period. And this is the highest output goal-wise for the Flames this season. And boys, they needed that. Now after the faceoff, Montador has it for the Flames. He'll wrap one off the back of the glass. Leafs inside of their own blue line. Now the Flames playing with a lot of boys right now. Puck comes back to Montador again. He deeks one. Shot goes to Hudson. Puck comes off the back of the glass. Into the opposite corner. Picking it up though for the Leafs. Thornton has it at center ice. Thornton goes in. Looks wide. Tries to squeak out in front. Doing it himself. And he ran out of room as Zuper got down in front. And the puck goes by the open side. Now a couple of players tying it up real close. And that's Rourke. And now Montador and Sean Thornton, I believe.
No, that's number 24, LaRiviere.
Oh, Jacques LaRiviere.
Things can get pretty heated up here now with 5:54 left to go in the third, and especially with the Leafs down 6-0.
Again, they're definitely taking exception. Now it looks as though the penalties are going to be called. And the referee, Kelly Sutherland, waving his arms a few times, so I'm sure that La Riviera is going to the penalty box for sure, as is Montador. And that could be the only penalties, but I believe there's a high sticking call, too. We'll have to wait for the official call on this one. 5:44 left here in regulation time. Flames lead 6-0.
It was a great rush, though, by Sean Thornton to go down there. Slid the puck out front, went right through the crease. But Super was laid right out, but the puck went right on through, didn't touch anybody. And the Flames are still up by a score of 6-0. I believe the Flames are going to get an extra two-minute minor here, and that could be the initial call. I think it was to Montador.
So Montador gets 2 minutes for high sticking, 2 minutes for roughing, and La Riviere picks up the roughing call, so it all boils down to a two-minute power play in favor of the Leafs. Adam Mayer to take the faceoff inside the Flames' blue line. Mayer handing out some directions, trying to get his boys in order. What the Leafs want to do now is just break the shutout bid by Levent Zucker.
Well, they want to break that goose egg that Zucker has down there and not let his confidence get up too much.
Right off of the faceoff, puck comes all the way into the player's bench. And Cooper decides that he's going to take it out of his hands and hand that over to a fan. So that's a good gesture by David Cooper. 33 for the Leafs, so they'll do the faceoff again from the same spot. Adam Mayer again to take the draw. He's out there with big number 27, Bobby House. On this penalty kill, off of the faceoff, a couple of players out of position, so they're going to do it all over again. And there's still 1 minute 54 seconds left in the high sticking call to Steve Montador. Off of the draw now, Leafs get it all the way back to the point. Rourke can't get anywhere as Mayer has it. Now they'll put it back to Rourke again, into Mayer. Mayer tried to take that one off his skate. Breton, Scoville out there. Scoville deep inside of his own corner now. Leafs come around the front of the crease. That one was redirected off of the skate of St. Croix. Adam Mayer turns around behind the playing goal. They'll send one over to the other side of the boards. That's kept in by the Leaf defenseman, Dempsey. Dempsey sends one right to the goal. Saved by Zucker, puck in front. And that one's in the net. And I believe Bobby House is going to get that goal. Now we've got a little scrum going on as a couple of players are up close and personal down on the ice. And this one could boil over.
Well, I think it could, and I think if we're going to call it Garby's goal of the night, I think that's going to have to be it right there, because Zucker should have had that coverage. The defenseman should have, you know, really should have had that lead player out of there. And you see Daryl Scoville throwing a little frustration with Rourke, give him a real good two-hander across the back. They couldn't get freed up enough to go, but nonetheless, I think they're going to go off for roughing if someone calls it. The Flames were not happy with that goal whatsoever.
Again, Bobby House got the garbage goal of the game last night, and he's a contender for two in a row. I don't know if he gets anything extra, but again, Johnny on the spot, I suppose, is there was a big scrum in front of the goaltender Zucker after he made the initial save, and House somehow managed to take a swing at the puck that was laying there, and it went past the line, and of course, the net did come off the mooring, but the goal was already in the net. And we've got some major penalties, I assume, being handed out, or minor penalties anyway, as the penalty box starting to pile up just a little bit. Still 4:56 left here in regulation time. Flames lead by a score of 6-1.
Well, there goes Super's shutout bid for tonight, but nonetheless a great showing. 6-1, 4:56 left to go in the third. And I think Super's kind of saying, you know, geez, what happened there? You know, I thought I had it, but the puck was a little bit loose, and Cooper just couldn't get to it at all, and House with Johnny on the spot, but nonetheless, I think Flames a little sloppy and cleared up the defenseman there, and let Cooper cover it up.
A little too complacent, maybe. Bobby House gets credit for the goal. Dempsey and Hackinson, I believe, are getting the assists, and that is the Leafs' first goal tonight. And again, penalties being handed out to, I believe, Daryl Scoville. and number 26 of the lease, and that is Alan Horton. Roughing Gauls back to the action. Both teams skating at four aside. Flames inside of their own blue line now. They'll hand it off onto the stick of Mike Martin. Martin puts it onto the stick of the forward. They'll get it in. Best shot from the point. Low just fired wide. Coming around the back of the goal, they'll do it again. Tried to put it onto the stick of Walzer. Walzer can't pick it up. Leafs try to get back down towards center ice. And the Leafs Cooper sends one in over the blue line. Flames, Kenny Karup out there. Roche was out there also. Now he goes to the bench. On comes Botterill. DuPont out there along with Morozic. And the Leafs inside of their own blue line. In doing the forechecking is Gratton. Leafs bring it back to center ice. Oh, they'll just lob one into the open corner. That one off of the stick of Bobby House. Flames try to pick it up. Now House comes in to pick up that loose puck. Turns around. Fires one. Save. That one was going under the crossbar, but Zuber saw it all the way.
Yes, he did, and it didn't go under the crossbar. It stayed in the twine, but the twine of Zuber's trapper is glove. He had a little pushing and shoving after the whistle there, too. We're going to see a lot of that, I think, coming on near the end of this game here. It's 3:49 left to go in the third period. That was a power play goal by the Leafs, and I don't know, kind of a sloppy goal. I thought it shouldn't have happened, but nonetheless, it did go in, and it's counted. Flames are leading, but it's for 6-1.
And there's still 3:49 left here in regulation time. Again, last night these two teams squared off, battled it out, went into overtime, ended up with a 3-3 tie. And tonight, the Flames took it to the Leafs right off the opening faceoff. A good first period, a good second period, and then just a little lackadaisy in period number three. And the Leafs right now, Barry, all they're trying to do is get some momentum going because they're heading off to Quebec to take on the Citadel in a couple of days, and they know that's going to be a tough game.
The Citadel's leading the Canadian division right now, too, and that's not a place you want to go into and suffering a loss like you did tonight.
Back to the action. Leafs inside of their own blue line. They'll shovel one up towards center ice. Bringing it in over the line was number 21, and that was Dempsey, who's logged a lot of ice time tonight. Flames now have control. They'll put it over onto the stick of Betts. Betts just puts one into the Leaf blue line, goes for a line change. On the ice now comes Tkachuk, Clark, St. Croix, and on the other side, Walzer. Flames still inside of their own blue line. Here comes Derek Walzer, heads up all the way, puts it right onto the tape of Clark. Clark in on the outside, brings it all the way into the corner. Clark still in control, tries to get rid of it, but can't do it at the right time. St. Croix fires one towards the goaltender, Hudson. And he had to open his legs a couple of times, wasn't sure where it was.
That just about slipped through the pads, and I think that would have been our garbage goal of the night right there, because that just goes to show what kind of night Hodgson's been having. I mean, that pretty much
exactly.
Went between the pads, and that there from just inside the blue line should not be happening at all. And he looked a couple of times to make sure it was there, and he's lucky he's not looking behind him to see the red light going.
So they'll have the faceoff to the near corner inside of the Leaf blue line. And taking this faceoff, it'll be Daniel Tkachuk. He's out there with Mika Lomo, Chris Clark. Back at the point, Walzer in St. Croix. Off of the faceoff, Clark snaps one. That goes off of a skate into the open corner, all the way back to the other point. Shot! Saved there by Hudson. Almost came out of his glove. And it did, but it was just past the outside of the post. So Hudson having a rough night here at the old office. And we'll have an offside call.
Another one that just about trickled over, you know, it hit his trapper and just trickled over and was into the crease area, but the Leafs defenseman was in there to clear it out, and luckily they're not down 7-1 here tonight.
He's been fighting with himself all evening long, and that's a little bit indicative of the way the score has gone, but again, the Flames really put the pucks to the starting goaltender right from the opening faceoff. But again, some of the players today at the early morning practice had an opportunity to talk to a couple of them, and they knew that it was a good game last night, but they really weren't pleased with the outcome. And I could tell, I've been around hockey long enough, that they meant business as soon as the puck dropped tonight. And so far, they have basically taken care of business and lead this game by a score of 6-1. 2:16 left here in regulation time. Flames have control inside of their own blue line, or at least rather, they'll get it up as far as center ice. Now the Flames turn it back over. They'll put it right onto the stick of Karup. Karup in over the blue line, near boards. He'll send one back behind the goal. Leafs elect to just jump it over the ice, and that one there, a good play by St. Croix, almost got away with it. But the linesman, and I believe that was Bobby Jones who whistled that one down, but a sneaky little play by St. Croix to try and keep that on a fair side.
Actually, that was Tim Skinner, and I've known Tim Skinner quite a while, and you're not going to fool him. He's been around the league too long. He's done a lot of refereeing, and he almost got away with it, but not quite. I mean, the hand was back behind the blue line, and he tried to snuff it down in, but just couldn't do it. So, see, LeRivière now in Krupp. I don't think Krupp will have anything to do with him. Krupp was voted the most sportsmanlike player in the OHL last year by his team in Ottawa. I don't think you're going to see him going.
LeRivière now wants to go with someone, and they're going to go. And I believe that is Steve Montador. As LeRivière, here comes a couple of lefts by Montador. Montador putting the fist to LeRivière. LeRivière, a little state of shock on his side, trying to battle back. But Montador now switches to the right, connects with a couple more. And LeRivière might just hang on for the show as they're still battling it out. But Montador switching left to right and making most of the damage. LeRivière now getting a couple of chops in as the linesmen elect to let them go. And now LeRivière wants to really tie up. But LeRivière, definitely the instigator, and Montador got the big one on that one.
I'd have to get the decision on that one to Montador. He led up some good ones at the first of it. I don't think LeRivière would be too happy with that one at all. But nonetheless, LeRivière got his shot in. The young kid, he's going to learn as time goes on. And there's a guy down south, by the name of Rocky Thompson, I think we'd love to have a piece of this little kid. Seen Rocky for the last few years, and it could get interesting. You see Sean Thornton down there, John with the bench too, and I think he's got his eye on somebody down there.
Oh, there's no doubt in my mind again. Tonight could be, again, there's only a minute 50 left here, but boys, Steve Montador and Jacques LeRivière decide to go toe-to-toe, and Montador, again, he switched from left, and you got to watch some softballs. I tell you, they could sneak them in a hurry, and Montador banged LeRivière.
Steve Bégin did that last week against, I believe it was a Finnish guy. He put him down to me, so I'm not even going to try, but Steve Bégin landed the first one with a left, and it surprised him, and put him down, so you got to watch them softballs, and I think Sean Thornton had a few words for Dave Roche there, and Dave Roche didn't back down one little bit from his words. So.
But again, what happened there was LeRivière was a little itchy, and he wanted to go with Karup, and Karup didn't want no part of it. So I think Monty decided then to give him a little call, and LeRivière went right over to Montador.
He was on the right street, but the wrong address.
And he got zip-coded out of province because Montador, again, looked really good in that situation. And that's twice I've seen Montador go to somebody else's aid. And, wow, he really put it to LeRivière. But needless to say, 1 minute 50 seconds left here in regulation time. The Flames on top by a score of 6-1. And still a lot of time left.
Coincidental minors there for fighting, actually, at 18-10.
And, of course, Thornton out on the ice, goes over towards number six, and that is Mike Martin, but Martin wants no part of it as the Leafs have control. Long pass down ice. Thornton going to race in, but Martin gets there first. Martin has that one go off of the edge of his stick, and that'll go all the way down the ice. And I believe it will go for icing as Dempsey touches it. So they'll bring it all the way back inside of the Flame blue line. With one win at 28 seconds left here in regulation time, the Flames lead by a score of 6-1.
Very good game here tonight. I guess you'd basically say a total team effort by the Flames. A great defensive game here tonight. Earlier in the game, the first period, we saw a lot of sloppiness going on. I think that was just kind of the feeling out process. And, you know, they've come on now to pull a 6-1 win out so far. There's 1:28 left to go in the third. The Flames led shots 34-23. The Leafs really picked it up here in the third period with their shots. So I think if there was another period here, we might have a different hockey game.
Again, the Flames a little bit of complacency in period number three, but here, Mickey Dupont not complacent. He'll take it all the way inside of the Leafs blue line, back behind the goal. Now Dupont decides he better get back into position as Martin had come over to pinch in for him. Puck comes across, Leafs going to intercept. Now they'll send it down towards center ice. Thornton in over the line, going in against Martin. Puck goes into the corner. Kachuk, he's that one off of the boards, kept in no by Thornton. Now Martin takes a elbow upper on the jaw. Less than a minute left in regulation time. Flames lead 6-1. They're on their way to a victory. Now the puck goes over. Faddock creates a little bit of havoc, but it's Elise who intercepts it inside of their own blue line. Now a couple of players is Thornton.
And Roach is out there now, too.
And
Thornton took a real run at Faddock. Roach has got to step in here now and take care of things.
Well, it's Thornton again. He's definitely itchy, and he wants to get something going, but the linesman very, very smartly get in there right away, and we'll have to wait and see. This is not over yet.
See, right now, that's the problem the Flames have. They don't have anybody that can step in there, throw a little intimidation out there, at least. I mean, you know, when Rocky was in, he just had to sit on the bench and nothing happened. I mean, I hate to go back to Rocky. You know, there was a lot of controversy going on last year, but still, when he was at least just sitting on the bench, none of this stuff really ever happened, eh? Because all he had to do was get a tap from former coach Rick Vibe, and that was it. He was, you know, he stepped out on the ice. Didn't have to do anything. Just go out on the ice, and that was all that had to be done. And you need that. You need that from an enforcer, whether it's a Thompson, a Thornton, or a Brashear in the NHL, a Domi. Just get on the ice. That presence is all you need.
There's a job description behind that, and I don't think...
I'm a policeman.
That's right, and I don't think LaRivière is going to fill Thornton's boots, that's for sure. But, of course, LaRivière is just 21 years of age.
Nonetheless, there's two junior players. They both played junior last year, so good touch. They probably, well, Monador's in the OHL, but nonetheless, I think they've known about each other. These guys that play junior, they hear about all these guys. They hear the Thorntons. They hear of all these other guys, and, you know, they keep up and keep in touch with hockey.
Well, Thornton, the only fellow to get the penalty. And the Flames on the power play. They have control inside of the Leafs' blue line. Leafs trying to get it out. They'll try and squeeze it down ice. St. Croix can't keep it in. He has to hustle back inside of his own blue line. And he'll just pass that one off with only 26 seconds left to go. Martin back behind his own goal. Takes the time. Again, they'll just probably ride the clock out here at Harbor Station with only 16 seconds left. Puck goes right at the blue line. Kept in there by Roche. Roche just gives it back to Morozic. Morozic over to St. Croix, back to Morozic. They'll just send it back and forth, and Levente Zucker getting his first win in the American Hockey League as the Flames have defeated the St. John's Maple Leafs by a score of 6-1.
Very good game. Zucker played a great game, and I think they'll play Fairfield. It's only one game, one win, but still, you gotta kind of feel good that, hey, I can look down the end of that bench if I need to, and I can put him out there and not have to worry too much about things. And Flames, you know, they got a big road trip coming up. That's two games in Hamilton. That can bump them up into third place. So they don't want to take this win too lightly, but you want to really take it to heart and take it with you when you go to Hamilton this week.
And they may well get a day off tomorrow, and a well-deserved day off it may be. We'll be right back. You're listening to Home Hardware Flames Hockey on Country 94.
Station tonight, St. John Flames with a huge win against the St. John's Maple Leafs. 6-1 the final. They outshot the Leafs 34-23. Levante Super gets his first win of the season, and a well-deserved win it was. He didn't have to face a lot of rubber in the first 40 minutes, but when he had to be sharp, he was indeed sharp. So the Flames back to the 500 mark, 3-3-3-1-1. And remain in fourth place in the Canadian division. St. John's Maple Leafs remain in second place, 1 point behind the Quebec Citadels. They are in action tonight, and we're still waiting for a final from that game. Once again, the final from Harbor Station, St. John Flames 6, St. John's Maple Leafs 1. Primetime Sports here on TVNB. Thanks for tuning in tonight. For Barry Johnston, I'm Jim Hennessy. Have yourself a good weekend. Thanks, guys.